Why not?
I like that color of spray paint.
Do we have a name for the podcast yet?
That's what I was thinking. How
like
about
like this specific one?
How about Fantasticals?
Wait. Like, is this the podcast, or are we gonna have other podcasts?
We're gonna have other podcasts.
Okay, we'll come up with names later.
Yeah, this is just the first podcast, and
this is my first podcast.
We'll call this Hi, of all time. Welcome.
My name's Jim.
My name's Jeff.
What the fuck?
My name's Jeff.
Hi, welcome to the Shooting Blanks podcast. I'm Kramer.
Oh, I'm Juan.
Yeah, he's Juan, and I'm Ryan.
And this is we're redoing our podcast. We might still have the old ones. I don't know yet.
Maybe.
But this is our first, I guess, nerdy podcast where we're specifically going into nerddom, comics.
I prefer geekdom.
Geekdom?
Geek.
You prefer geekdom?
We're geeks. Nerds are like.
Like computer nerds?
Computer nerds, you know, math and
science.
No,
that's geeks. Geeks are the ones with the pocket protectors.
No, geeks are. I could have sworn geeks are like comic nerds.
No, it's nerds.
Nerds are the
ones into like nerd culture, and geeks are the like pocket protectors and programmers.
Yeah. Mm. I only know the term if someone insults me.
Well, no.
Okay, you insult me.
You're the deal breaker.
Kramer, you say nerd in an insulting way.
Nerd!
No.
No.
You can't just do Revenge of the Nerds.
Piccolo and Gohan.
Okay, that was kind of nerdy. Go into Revenge of the Nerds.
I went to DBZ.
Okay. You went to DBZ?
Do
Dragon Ball Z Abridged.
Do a what? Geek like.
You're a fucking geek.
Well, no, because
I'm not buying it.
Well,
because
they have Rhett versus Link, where they do geek versus nerd, and the nerd is supposed to be like the pop culture one who uses apps and all that shit, and like he's into video games, and the geek one is the guy who programs computers and shit.
You know, I don't know, man.
It was explained to me, because I used to watch Junkyard Wars, where they would find scraps in the junkyard and build like machines to fight each other out of them.
I've never heard of that.
You've never seen that before? I thought it was a pretty cool show.
It sounds cool.
Sounds not cool. Keep going.
It was awesome.
I just like
it sounds cool, Kramer.
See, now I feel nerdier than ever bringing up this show.
I think it sounds cool.
Because they would talk about like the physics of like building shit and, you know, well, fuck y'all.
That is pretty nerdy.
But they had two teams one time where it was like the geeks versus the nerds. And the nerds were like, no, we're better than the geeks because, you know, the geeks are the ones who just study at home all night. The nerds actually try to go out and party every once in a while, even though we get made fun of.
I don't think any of them party.
You don't think any of them party?
No, I don't think so.
Okay, how about this?
I mean, I like to party.
Well, they try to party, but they're not good at it.
Hmm. Okay.
What do you call the people who dress up as knights and fight each other?
Nerds.
I
call the guy.
You know what? I think the thing is I've never used the term geek.
Well, it's because geeks never leave the house.
I've never used the term nerd.
That's because you are a nerd. You don't.
If I had to describe, like, if I describe stuff to someone else, I'd be like, oh yeah, I'm nerdy about this or that. I've never used.
Could we just toss the labels, period?
Yeah.
I just like the way nerd sounds.
All right. Can't say toss the labels and just use. Can we just, you know, we'll just not use labels.
Oxymoron.
If I had to pick one, you know, nerd.
All right, on to the next period then.
Okay.
Which is?
Well, this is our nerd/geeky podcast where we're going to be talking about comics, anime.
Pop culture?
Pop culture-ish.
You say Aunt May?
Anime?
I thought you said Aunt May.
We're specific.
Aunt May.
This is
specifically Aunt May.
Specific Aunt May podcast only dealing with her and her possible spin-off movie.
Speaking of which,
no,
the Sony possible spin-off movie
apparently
that they wanted.
Apparently, it was real.
Or she was going to be a spy, and they denied it, but it's true.
Because it was in their emails.
Yes, they're like, we would never do that, and then the Sony hacked emails said we wanted to do that.
What? Like Aunt May, like from Spider-Man, right?
Yes, Aunt May
with Sally Field.
She was gonna be.
I didn't know it was gonna be Sally Field.
Well, she was Aunt May. Well, May. It would have been a younger woman.
So like, what kind of spy? I don't understand this.
Well, okay, so Peter's parents were spies in the Amazing Spider-Man movies.
Mm-hmm.
No, they weren't.
No,
they're spies in the comics. They're part of S.H.I.E.L.D. in the comics.
Oh,
in the movie, they were scientists on the run.
In the movie, it's very vague.
They were killed for some reason.
See, I keep feeling like they're trying to link up all the movies together, but they just can't because of like the company contracts and shit.
The trademarks?
Yeah.
Trademarks, yeah. Ownership and copyright. And so now Marvel owns Sony, basically, since they share Spider-Man. Because Spider-Man's all Sony has.
Mm-hmm.
So.
And now that they're sharing it, yeah.
I mean, they got that in PlayStation. That's about it. So.
But besides the Aunt May thing.
She was cast, though.
Well, by the way, Marissa Tomei.
Oh, I heard that. Marissa Tomei? Awesome. I'm totally on board.
Totally. See, it's weird for me because whenever I heard about would see Spider-Man and stuff like that, I always thought Aunt May was the older, grandma kind of lady.
She's 50.
She is.
Marissa Tomei's 50?
Yeah. She's 50.
She looks pretty damn good for 50.
She looks almost exactly the same as my cousin Vinny.
When I was younger. Even still now, that's still my female crush.
Oh, yeah. Marissa Tomei. I had a crush on her from watching my cousin Vinny. I'm like, yeah.
But it's so weird because now I can't watch Spider-Man and be like, you know what? I would totally whack it to Aunt May.
She's 50 and the new guy's 18. So it's appropriate age difference. I mean,
I guess. It works. It makes sense.
Yeah.
And plus, I think they're going for more of Ultimate Spider-Man comic books, which it was. That was a retelling in 2000. Mm. And Aunt May was more. A reboot? It was not a reboot of the comics, but it was just.
It was like freshening it up. On the side. Up, adding some sass to it.
Yes. And Aunt May was a hippie, younger hippie Aunt May in that comic book.
Well, that works.
I can see that. Okay. Paul Rudd did play a hippie in that. Our idiot brother. Yeah.
That was.
I saw a trailer for that yesterday.
I saw the movie, and I liked it up to a point.
I don't even remember the movie.
It got up to a point where it's like, yeah, this guy's stupid, and that's over. Already.
He's too.
We get it.
We get it. Yeah.
I think Paul Rudd did an amazing job in Ant-Man, by the way.
Yes. I think so too.
I know a lot of people. Adrian in particular, I don't know. Have you seen Ant-Man?
Oh, yeah.
Our friend Adrian, because I kept telling him, hey, let's go watch Ant-Man. He's like, I don't want to watch fucking Ant-Man.
My brother was like that.
And he did really? It. He didn't come with us to watch Ant-Man.
No, and I tried to tell him, but Paul Rudd is in it. He's like, I don't fucking care. It was like, that boggled my mind because I love Paul Rudd.
Yeah. But he's like, he's playing a superhero, was everyone's reaction to it. And I was like, he's Chris Pratt, dude. He pulled it off. You know,
he's basically Paul Rudd, except now he's in a suit.
See, Chris Pratt actually changed character though. He changed the kind of character he portrays. He didn't do the goofball.
Yeah,
but he did kind of the badass, sarcastic.
He definitely wasn't Andy Dwyer, but
he wasn't Andy Dwyer.
But he is still Andy Dwyer.
He was a less dumb Andy.
Yeah, he was a cool Andy.
Yeah,
how Andy tries to be cool. If Andy actually pulled off being cool, that was him in Galaxy.
Oh, yeah. So he was basically Burt Macklin.
Oh, yes!
That took me a second.
Same, yeah.
His dream came true.
Burt Macklin.
Yes, he was Burt Macklin.
Oh, man.
He did a great job.
FBI.
Oh, my God. No, but Paul Rudd is still Paul Rudd.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, he was very Rudd.
Yeah.
God, he was cut, though, man.
Dude.
He went through the Marvel Get in Shape program. Yeah.
I want that program. Holy shit.
There was no need for that scene. There was one scene where he's just turned sideways and he's touching his cut on his.
Well, they had
super
to do something
body.
To where the girl would find him attractive. What was her name?
Jane?
Hope.
Jane.
Thor's. That's Thor.
Also, I've been watching Breaking Bad. Jane was the girl. Was Jesse's girlfriend. I think.
No, I don't think Jane.
I'm pretty sure.
Jane.
Let's not correct this. And just
keep going. I don't know what the fuck you're talking about anymore.
Anyway. Well, yours,
Hope. They had to have some point where Hope looked at him and found him attractive. It wasn't good enough that they had that bonding moment in the car. She actually kind of had to look at him and be like, So they needed something for that.
So what you're saying is she couldn't just fall in love with him based on his awesome personality?
And heart?
I guess that's what I'm saying, yeah.
She needed the mind and body.
Body helps.
She was kind of a
shitty one. To be fair,
yeah, I didn't.
Paul Rudd won me over way before the apps.
It's the eyes.
He won me over in the very first scene.
Dreamy Paul Rudd.
He's just so
Can you believe?
Aloof.
Can you believe he's 40 or something? He's 40.
No, he's 50.
Something.
He's 50?
No.
No, yeah. No,
he must be late.
No. Robert Downey Jr. is 50.
Yeah, he's almost 50. Dude, freaking Daniel Craig is isn't he almost 50?
But
already?
he looks like an old man.
Kind of Daniel Craig has the wrinkles.
I kind of like the idea of an older James Bond, but he's pulling it off, I think. The next movie looks good.
Oh, The Spectre?
Yeah.
I just saw the new trailer for it.
Skyfall was awesome, so I'm excited for Spectre.
I just kind of stopped watching him. I still watch the trailers, but I stopped watching
him. Skyfall.
Oh, Skyfall. For a moment, I thought you said Scar-Ho, and I was like, what?
Scar-Ho. Scar-Jo. Sorry.
So we segue straight into Ant-Man then?
Yeah.
We were going to save this till last.
We could do Ant-Man last. We'll come back to it.
Unfortunately, we didn't make the list.
We did not make the list. I know I said I was going to make a list, but But we didn't.
Okay, then let's start with the main thing that I'm really fucking excited about, since there's Suicide Squad.
I was about to say Warner Brothers shit.
Yeah. Yeah. Well, Suicide Squad is not what I'm super excited for. I'm excited for Batman Superman.
Really?
Yes.
I am excited for that. I'm kind of more excited for Suicide Squad.
I'll even it out and say both of them have me hard.
Yeah, yeah. They're good, but like, I felt so much more excitement to Batman Superman.
I mean, Batman
I'm
Superman
not super familiar
it.
With Suicide Squad.
It had a great. Well,
neither
trailer.
Am I, and that's why I like it.
Mm-hmm. Like, when they showed like the other characters, like I kind of know a couple of them, but I don't know anything about them.
You know what's funny?
So there was no connection.
Sony really wanted to do Sinister Six, right?
Yes.
And they wanted to do their big like villains movie. They were going to be the first ones.
There was going to be like a villain heist movie or something.
And now Warner Brothers got the jump on that with Suicide Squad.
Well, they had to do something because Marvel was like kicking their ass in terms of movies for a while. I mean,
in terms of number and money.
It's because like Marvel did this thing where, and correct me if I'm wrong, I haven't seen it done in movies yet, where they're coming out with like 20 different movies and they're all connected. They're basically doing a TV series in the form of movies.
Yeah, it's
the universe.
It's pretty unprecedented.
Yeah,
I would say it's
unless you count that E.T. and Star Wars are in the same universe, which they are.
We're not going through that.
That was done before.
This conspiracy.
It's not a conspiracy. In Star Wars Attack of the Clones, you see E.T.'s race on the Senate floor, which means that they're in the same universe.
Oh my god, you're right.
Ah, look who had it before.
Wait, but that was episode 3?
Two. Attack of the Clones.
The worst.
The worst one?
Yes!
Oh my god.
I feel like they did that just to do it. It didn't seem like that was the original idea.
They did it because in Star Wars, original Star Wars, Obi-Wan mentions in one line, "Oh yes, he fought with me during the Clone Wars, your father."
Yes.
And that was it. It's never spoken of again. And then George Lucas was like, "Well, I guess we can make a whole movie about this."
George Lucas at one point was boasting about it being a 12 movie saga.
Fuck, that's way too long.
12 movies. Was it 9? I think he said 12. Well, and then he totally backed out.
Well, but even if you consider like E.T. with the Star Wars movies, that's still only like 7 movies if you count E.T.
Well, E.T. wasn't done by him. That was Steven Spielberg.
Oh, then they can't be connected.
They are connected. Like, it was kind of like a nod to each other.
I'm hanging on to the idea that was just an Easter egg or something.
That's what I'm saying. It's more like hey, let's throw this in there.
To say, you know, it's like a mutual respect thing. But
for
like,
some reason,
if they have the E.T. alien, then like... It does. Then you think about like, oh, they are the same universe.
Well, but they
at some point.
See, they tried to do that connection also by putting like they pointed out that there were Star Wars toys in the E.T. Movie.
Mm-hmm.
But that just means that that Star Wars was a movie in that movie.
Maybe they think it's a movie,
but it's actually E.T.'s
But it's
history.
Based on real life from a long time ago.
In a galaxy far, far away.
I can't handle that.
Actually, really
That's a
close.
Too much.
That part that got wrong.
Okay. A friend of mine, real quick, a friend of mine and I, now this is another tangent.
But we've gone on so many tangents.
We were talking about, like, can you imagine the day when they reboot E.T.?
No.
No.
I don't want to see
And
it.
He's just like, there's got to be some things that are too sacred, you know, like to touch.
I wouldn't put it past
I wouldn't put it
them,
past
but them. I don't want to see it.
Damn it. Now there's another tangent because there's the rumors. Of Back to the Future.
No, I was going there.
I've heard about it.
And I'm going to crush your rumors. Tell me what you're going to say right now.
I heard a rumor that Back to the Future was going to be remade.
Crushed. Robert Zemeckis himself owns the copyright, and he said, no one will get Back to the Future until I die.
Good man. Good man.
And he says, and when I die, my estate will fight for it so bad.
Good
he said, no one is remaking Back to the Future. Thank God for Robert Zemeckis.
Good, because that did not need to be remade. The trilogy was great as it was.
It's the best.
It needs to end there.
It's like my favorite movies.
Okay.
Going back.
Back to the Marvel thing. Marvel basically did this thing where they have a whole universe now. Even if you count the Star Wars, like all 7 of them together.
That's a story, though. That's a single story.
But Marvel is doing this thing where it's like, it's like you said, it's a universe. It branches out. And so far, they have like 20 movies planned.
Yeah.
And DC kind of had, you know, the Batman series. And then they had the Superman series, but they weren't connected at all. And... they were kind of getting their asses kicked because Marvel is like, what they were doing was just so awesome, and DC was like, come on, guys, come on. Why aren't we doing this?
Well, I'm going to blow your minds. I don't know if y'all know this. Do y'all know who was the front runner for Iron Man?
Who was the original person to be in it?
One of the actors that they approached first.
Before, besides our DJ?
Yeah.
Was it Tom Cruise?
Yeah.
I would have hated that.
You know, ironically enough, Robert Downey Jr. doesn't play comic book Iron Man.
Right. He's completely different.
He's very different. He made really? It his own thing. Oh, he's totally different. They're starting to sort of write Iron Man, kind of Robert Downey Jr. is, but...
But it's weird because didn't... Why can't I remember his name?
Tom Cruise?
No, the guy who wrote Marvel. The
guy who wrote Marvel?
Stan Lee. Like
he based it on himself. He based the look on himself and everything.
Oh, my God.
He totally did. He looks like him back in the day. He totally does.
Well, but like he was saying that that Robert Downey Jr. was made for this role. Like he said he plays it exactly the way he wants him to.
I think Stan Lee just likes everything.
Hey, I mean, he
just loves literally everything. I've never heard a bad word come out of his mouth.
Do you think like he made Iron Man one way, and then when he saw Robert Downey Jr. play it, he was like, damn it, why didn't I write it like this?
Maybe. I think it's very successful portrayal,
I think that's all, like, it's the who's in charge of Marvel right now, Kevin Feige?
Yeah.
That's all, like, his brainchild. Because I read somewhere that when they were pitching Iron Man, it was, like, a big stretch. He had to explain to people that, like, he's not a robot. He's a guy in a suit that looks like a robot. So they based it off the idea that, like, no one knows who Iron Man is, so we can take liberties with how he's supposed to be, and no one's going to care.
Yeah, he's a very... Okay. He was pretty much a C to D list character,
and he's like a drunk.
As far as popularity,
he's a drunk in there too.
Well, see, that's what really confused me about with Ant-Man, because they were saying Ant-Man was the least successful of the Marvel movies so far.
So far, it is.
Yeah,
I've heard.
But Iron Man, who was also like one of the not so familiar characters, like it blew everything out of the water when Iron Man came out.
But I mean,
everyone
was that first
of its kind
drop into the pool.
You had shit, and then Iron Man came out, and you're like, oh. This is really
good. And it came out the same year Dark Knight came out. And people were high on that shit.
And they blew people like away.
Actually, Iron Man came out first.
Before Dark Knight?
Yeah. So Batman Begins had come out years prior.
Oh, okay. Well, Batman Begins was good, but it wasn't like... It wasn't amazing.
I love the movie, but it wasn't a huge hit.
Yeah.
But Tom Cruise would have played like a comic book Iron Man. Things would have been so different.
I don't think I would have liked that, no.
I don't like Tom Cruise.
They based the portrayal of him in one of the comics at the time of like the rumors that he was playing it.
I don't know how I feel about that.
I think that Warner Brothers has got a good plan going.
Do you think they're going to come out with just as big of a universe, though?
Oh,
yeah.
Yeah. Have you seen their slate?
They have...
No. I've seen like the different pictures for like Aquaman and Wonder Woman and stuff like that.
They're doing the same thing till 2020.
I know the order of things up to a point. It's Batman, Superman... Next year, Suicide Squad. Wonder Woman's next. Mm-hmm. And JL, part one.
Mm. Wait.
Justice League, part one.
Is Aquaman not getting a movie before JL?
He is not.
Mm. He's getting it before part two, though, right?
But he's going to appear in Batman Superman, is what people think, which is probably going to be the formation of Justice League.
See, this is kind of upsets me a little bit, because it feels like, you know, with Marvel, they started off with, like, all the different ones.
Yeah.
They tied it in.
I know exactly what he's going to say.
Mm-hmm. Marvel, or not Marvel, DC kind of did the opposite. They're like, here's everybody in one movie, and we'll just toss out other movies here and there.
They're taking the opposite
approach.
We'll
see if it works. I mean, I think it's beneficial for them to try things differently.
Yeah, because you can't build up the same
way.
They
already did with Man.
They're going to build up the big group, and then once that movie's good, they'll give everyone their individual movie to, like, you can see more of them.
Now, do you think, like, in terms of, like, Aquaman, because I know Aquaman, we've had this conversation, Aquaman's very underrated.
Yeah.
Yes.
But do you think it's going to be the same thing where, like Iron Man came out and it was like, holy shit, Iron Man, this guy that we never used to talk about before and he's fucking awesome. Do you think the same thing is going to happen with Aquaman, or do you think it's going to be the Ant-Man reaction when they're like, eh, it's fucking Aquaman?
Well, I don't know. Based on the picture,
he looks badass.
There was a big positive response to how he looked.
That's the guy from Game of Thrones, right?
Yes.
Yeah. I think he's going to be... like, just as cool as he is, like, in the comics.
Oh, yeah.
Okay.
I think he's going to be, like, super mean and just kind of, like...
I want them to accentuate, like,
strong.
His other, like, powers besides just the talking to the fish.
Which he actually doesn't really
do. Yeah, he doesn't talk to fish. He messes with their fish brain.
He has, like, a sonar-type telepathic power.
Kind of like the Ant-Man with the ants.
Yes. Yeah. Very similar to that. What was I going to say? I think that my brother and I were talking about this, about how DC superheroes, I feel like they have always been, the Justice League in particular, have always been much more well-known just in pop culture, in general pop culture, than like the Avengers.
Yeah.
And I think doing a Justice League movie first, I think it's fine.
Because they'll get these attention that people already have heard of them.
Yeah, people know Aquaman. He's king of the sea. You know, that's basically it. People know Flash, especially since Flash is big right now on the TV.
Mm-hmm.
And, go ahead.
I was going to say, that was another question. Are they going to use the same actors?
No.
No?
No, they're not connected. No. Is what they're saying.
Which is weird. They're already developing him. They might as well.
Yeah, it seems like the logical choice to just connect them.
I don't know. Things can get muddled between trying to connect TV to movies. They can get muddled.
It's going
to
be the Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D.
They're going to limit what they can do on TV, and then they're going to limit what they can do on movies based on what they do on TV.
But here's the thing. With Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D., don't they use some of the same actors from like the Marvel movies? They still have...
Coulson.
But that's close enough. My problem is for me, like, I feel, especially like from what I've seen, Green Arrow, that is, he's a great actor.
Yeah, he's great.
And I think he would be great in a movie.
Yes. We're about to see him, too.
My issue...
is Casey Jones.
Oh, Casey Jones, yeah.
Is that if they don't use those actors, it's not going to be because it was too hard to tie in the series to the movie, because they could do that.
It was going
to
be because they have a different vision or something like
that. No. Not even that. I'm worried that they're going to do some shit like, we don't want to use them because those actors are already moderately successful and they're going to ask for more money. We'd rather get unknown actors who don't charge as much.
TV actors aren't that expensive.
Yeah,
nobody's gonna be getting Robert Downey Jr. money for a while. Not till Ben Affleck makes his Batman movie.
That's true. Once Ben Affleck's movie is like awesome,
I went crazy over that news.
Didn't you say you cried?
Huh?
Didn't you say you cried?
No, I cried at the trailer.
Okay, the trailer.
No, I was ecstatic because Ben Affleck's gonna write. He's gonna co-write the script with Jeff Johns.
Oh, is he?
Jeff Johns, big time DC comic writer. He brought Ant-Man back. In a big bad way. He did a huge run on Green Lantern. And he's done other things. He's been very, very beneficial for DC. Mm. He's going to co-write it with him and direct it.
For the next Batman movie?
The next Batman solo movie. And, of course, star in it as Batman.
Now, were you nervous when you found out that Ben Affleck was going to be Batman?
Exact opposite reaction.
You were excited,
the consensus.
Right?
Why did I never think of that? You know, I think he's perfect. I think he's perfect for
it. At the time, yes, very. Going off of Daredevil.
Which was 2003.
And Giggly?
And
Giggly?
Any other... Geely? Geely? Yeah.
Giggly.
No.
Geely.
It's
Geely.
It's Jiggly.
I thought it was Giggly.
I'm pretty sure it's...
I thought it was Giggly. No, it's...
Going off like his past movies. But then, like, after that was announced, the movies that he's come out now are, like, been really, really good.
He's the bomb in Phantoms, yo.
Affleck was the bomb. Dude, I bought Phantoms.
Did you really?
I bought it for 60 cents on VHS.
Wow. He's a very different actor today, though. Very different. He's
now
a great director.
He's very good.
I didn't know he was writing, like, doing part of the writing for it.
Me neither. I thought he was just going to direct.
Whoa. He was directing it, too?
I'm sure he's learned a lot from, like,
Argo?
Chris Terrio?
He directed Argo, what?
Chris Terrio is a writer he's worked with before, and Chris Terrio is co-writing Batman vs. Superman with the writer of Man of Steel, which David S. Goyer.
Wait, what's Ben Affleck writing?
He's writing his Batman solo. He's co-writing
He's co-writing the Batman solo.
Yeah.
Okay.
And Jeff Johns writes Batman books, too, and good ones. So that's just a good dynamic duo.
You said Jeff Johns did Ant-Man, too? Like the... He wrote Ant-Man?
No, some Aquaman.
Aquaman. Oh, Aquaman. Okay.
Can I also say that I really like that DC is doing the much darker, like...
I don't know why people can't get over that.
I like it.
It's like they're taking it seriously. I think these heroes deserve to be taken seriously every once in a while, you know?
It's a bit more realistic when things are darker, because in those worlds, it's not going to be happy-go-lucky. It's going to be...
I wouldn't even call it darker, though. I think Batman's movie will be darker. They're just taking it more seriously. It's got a more... dramatic, realistic setting.
Yeah,
like they're taking.
It's also supposed to be real world.
It's very real world. Yeah.
For me, that's when I first thought that was when I saw Aquaman's new outfit. Mm-hmm. Instead of the green and orange, it was just like the all black, and I was like, that seems much more realistic.
Yeah, he's got like gold plates in some areas, and then strap, and then.
Yeah, but it's not like the bright. He doesn't look like a carrot snack.
Yeah. Oh my god. Yeah. No, okay, it's gold now. It's not orange anymore.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But I'm excited for it. I think that I'm excited for Wonder Woman in particular.
Are you really?
I liked how what she looked the trailer.
I mean, the actress.
Yeah.
I gotta see her to see, you know, because she's. I don't recognize she doesn't her have from acting anything. Cred behind her for sure.
She doesn't, or she does?
No, she doesn't.
Because she was just in Fast and Furious.
She was
right?
in Fast and Furious. That's what we Which all are know not. Her for.
Wait. Good. Who was she in Fast and Furious?
Minor character.
Was she minor character?
She died in the recent. In, I don't not know. The recent one, but the one.
Was she like the?
Spoiler alert.
The main like love interest.
No, that's Michelle Rodriguez.
No, not Michelle Rodriguez. The other love interest.
For Paul Walker?
Paul Walker's love
no,
interest.
No.
Then who the fuck was she?
She was Han's love interest. Han?
No, not Han.
Man, forget
from Tokyo
it. Was so
Drift?
Cool.
Yeah, man.
Wait, from the from
you know
Tokyo
who killed
Drift?
Han?
Or
you know
from...
who killed Han? Spoiler alert.
Crank.
It was...
Yeah. I know that, yeah.
Fucking... Oh, my God. That they did an end credits for that movie.
Yeah.
You don't know who I am. You're about to find out.
Jason Statham, like, I'm sure they give him a script of like 5 lines.
That's actually
and it probably
one.
Takes him like 10 minutes to say. They're like, you're gonna say this 5 sentences, and he's like, okay, but I'm gonna break it up very dramatically.
God damn it. What were we saying?
We're talking about Suicide
Wonder
Squad.
Wonder Woman.
I think maybe I'm not as excited because I haven't seen the actress before, so I don't know what to expect. Like, I'm excited for Aquaman because I've seen the guy in Game of Thrones. I'm excited for the Batman one just because I want to see Ben Affleck pull this off. I really do.
He convinced me as soon as he started running towards that building.
Yes, right? He's running everyone.
Not that he needed to convince me, but I was just like, I'm sold again.
It's so Batman. Everyone's going away. Yeah. He's the only one charging straight like into that cloud of dust.
And that face of anger.
That face he's when he's on the phone.
Oh,
and
he's got like four
and you can see the laser going through the building from Man of Steel.
Yeah, that's a great shot of continuity.
Yeah, that's really cool.
I was like, he was there.
He was there the whole time.
Changes everything. Not really, but it does.
But it adds some cool like insight to that. It's really cool.
That to me, it also adds to like the dark part of it though, because originally Superman's the one who doesn't kill anybody. But did he killed a bunch of people in the first one, right? Were there a bunch of civilians?
Okay, look,
dude.
Okay,
that's
look.
The biggest thing that everyone
I know.
Always claims.
We don't need to start trying to defend it.
I'm not gonna defend it.
I'm just
I'm
gonna
totally
say.
Like that. They're defending it, and I feel like it's very wrong. Like
they're defending what?
Like okay,
and who's they?
What's wrong?
I'm talking about first off in Man of Steel, clearly. Hundreds of thousands of people were killed.
Yes.
Right? Agreed?
Yeah.
Okay, in the new trailer and in previous things, because they got a lot of heat for that.
Oh, in that building, they say dozens.
It says killed. Dozens killed.
Well,
fuck off with that.
They said
dozens killed. And then, what's his name? The director was saying of Man of Steel ended up saying, like, it was only like 5,000 people that died. I'm like, fuck you. You know damn well that it's not. Which is why I feel Avengers made such a big effort, the new one, to rescue as many people as possible from Sokovia.
I didn't
so
like
they don't
that.
Get the same...
I didn't like that because it was an obvious...
The same, like, flack from Man of Steel.
I didn't like that just because it was an obvious finger point.
Yeah.
It was an obvious finger point.
It had to be. Because they were like, well, Superman didn't save anyone, and people kind of aren't liking that. He literally saved one family. By snapping someone's neck.
But it makes
neck.
It so much more realistic, though. It makes it, I mean, Superman literally can't get away with, like, and for me, there's, have you guys ever played Jack and Daxter?
No.
Yeah, I've seen it.
The first game was all, like, happy-go-lucky, and then the second game is a lot darker, and you cannot play the second or third game without civilian casualties. It is impossible. I've tried. It's just not gonna happen. You kill people just walking down the street because of like the way you drive the motorbikes and shit. It's so hard to control. You just kill people running into them.
I'm not defending.
I'm gonna defend it.
I get it. It was his first time.
It makes it realistic.
He's trying to save the world.
He's
I
learning
get it.
To be a hero. There's gonna be casualties in the process when a bunch of aliens come at him to like destroy humanity.
I get that. That's not the problem for me. The problem is Zack Snyder and them are saying. No, but it really wasn't a lot of people that died.
Well, okay.
Just say yes, there was a lot of people.
So you're saying they're being pussies about it.
Do you think that in the if you take a look at some of the shots in the movie, people act like when the that gravity thing was going on in the city, it took out half the city. It was not half. It was a couple of blocks.
Okay.
Do you think people wouldn't run away from something like that?
They would, but it was kind of sucking things, like, weirdly.
Yeah, people were dying.
I'm sure it was a gravity thing. They couldn't run away. It's gravity.
Yeah, if you see a spaceship like, appear above you, people are going to start evacuating. And people started evacuating Metropolis. It was shown.
So that's basically that what they're saying, yeah.
So
I don't know. When the hurricane comes, people still don't run. They just stand there at the beach going, oh, look at the fucking hurricane.
Well, I'm not convinced 5,000 people died in that. Yeah. I'm convinced tens of thousands, maybe. 10,000 or more. You know, because a couple of blocks of tall buildings... that are, what, 50?
What if you count people that just, like, died from all the smoke inhalation?
There's that, I mean...
Like, after the fact.
People dying from cancer years later.
Yes.
There's that, but in the article...
Too deep.
It says dozens dead.
It says dozens.
But I thought they were talking about the Wayne Building falling.
It just seems oddly specific to only talk about that building.
It's well, wasn't it a Gotham newspaper he was
holding?
Was
it a Saturday?
Oh, you know what?
Less
what?
People go to work on was a Saturday. That's all I'm saying.
Was it a Saturday? Maybe they could explain it. Like, I get what you're saying. Like,
this is too
it could
realistic.
Be a weekend. Not a lot of people were at work.
Too realistic.
Maybe it was like it got night really quickly, didn't it? Wasn't it like maybe
it got night
real quickly? Like it turned into night.
Okay,
the night.
I'm having a hard time trying to say that as well. It turned yeah, dark fast. It turned dark quickly. No, it was smoke and because
you know, I was gonna say maybe the fight started late in the day. Maybe everyone was already leaving downtown.
I was scared you were gonna make a Dark Knight pun.
I almost did.
He tried to.
Like it's the Wayne Building, so it was a Dark Knight.
Well, okay, like I was saying before, it said dozens dead in like Wayne Building or something like
yeah.
that.
Oh, yeah.
That could have been people in the building. It could have been people the building falling on some people.
Could have been family members that just happened to die from seeing the news of the building fall.
Oh my God.
What if the dozens that they're talking about were just Wayne family members? Like the
more
few,
family members?
The few that he had left.
Well, so like Bruce's
after
the last
his
one.
Parents
like,
died.
Second cousin.
They're
cousins.
Like, you know what? Let's remember my mother and father by inviting the rest
so
of my
angry.
Family
yeah.
over.
That's why he's so
we'll
mad.
Do a family reunion. Hey guys, just hang out here at my building. I'm gonna go grab a pizza real quick.
I'm gonna go
and
get
then
us
he comes
catered
back,
lunch, guys.
And like,
he's
the
like,
rest
Jerry
of his that's why he's so angry, because his parents died and now Superman kills the rest of his bloodline.
I like that. I like that theory a lot. He found like I want it to be just like five people. He found just five fifth cousins.
His Aunt May.
Aunt May and Uncle Ben.
Third cousin twice removed.
Yep. He's like, you know what? We're family. I got nothing else.
My last name's not even Wayne.
No, he died.
There's a lot of controversy over the movie that I don't think all of it holds up, but...
There's always going to be controversy.
I think the premise of Batman v Superman, you know, having Supes answer for everything that went down.
Yeah.
I think that makes sense.
I like that.
I think that...
That's cool.
It's a good take.
I originally was wondering, like, how are they going to make it Batman versus Superman? Because I've never read the comics where they fight each other. And I was always wondered how they're going
to... They've never gone this far with it in the comics.
Like the way when they pitch them against each other?
In the comics, their first meeting is always like, neither of them like the way they operate. Neither of them like the way each other operates.
And eventually they just get into each
like,
other's
I don't
nerves
like you.
And they fight.
And then they immediately have a villain to fight together.
But it doesn't get really far because like, they end up just kind of like.
The most notable
stopping.
One is The Dark Knight Returns.
Yeah, that one's a good one.
And that was just Superman being a government lackey and Batman not liking that.
Mm. Well, he only didn't like when Superman started having to. Tell him, like, look, can't be the Batman no more.
Yeah, yeah.
He's like, fuck you, Bruce.
Fuck you, Clark.
I'm pretty sure those were his exact words. Fuck you. Leave me the fuck alone.
Did you say Bruce?
Yeah, he's McClark. He meant
oh,
Clark.
Yeah, McClark.
I'm going to come to you being the Batman. Fuck you, Clark. You're going to tell me who to be.
But
I am the Knight.
No.
Man,
no.
Man
you're
Steel.
Bruce. I'm the Knight.
Superman... He didn't directly cause any deaths in the movie.
No.
There were two moments where he acted like too quickly, he didn't think about it, and he went through like a gas station. You know? But that was it was right in the part where he was threatening his mom.
Mm-hmm.
Right? And so I'm like, okay. He wasn't that. Thinking right there. He yeah. went through a fucking gas station. Idiot. But, you know, first time. But for the most part, he never threw Zod through a building. He was thrown through buildings, and he didn't destroy property on purpose. I remember there being this one shot which I thought was hilarious when Zod pushes a like an 18-wheeler with, you know, huge oil tanks or whatever into a parking garage, and it explodes, and you see all these cars falling, and it's a far shot, and you see Superman turn around and look at it and be like, oh, I could have done something about this one. But there was nobody in the cars, nobody in the building.
He's like, oh, fuck.
Because he dodged it instead of trying to, like, stop it.
Mm. Yeah. But see, I get that. That's cool. That's learning, you know?
Hopefully, that's, yeah, it's, like, it's a really subtle way of showing him acknowledging what's going on around him.
As long, yeah, like, none of that, like, I like the movie, so.
No, that Superman movie, I really like.
It's divisive as hell, and that's something I like about it as well, you know? That wasn't. I don't think they made that movie thinking like everyone will like this, especially coming out. It was 2013, so they'd already had a couple Marvel movies.
Mm-hmm. Yeah,
and I don't think there was no way they could. They were thinking, you know, everyone will like this the same way they like Iron Man. You know, no, it was really different.
But that's what I like, the direction that they're going in. They're trying to make it more serious. They're trying to make it like
it's dark and gritty.
I kind of like the dark and gritty, though.
I definitely got a Watchmen vibe from the trailer, though.
Oh.
And I like that. The visually look Watchmen. Right? It was, I don't think we're going to see a big blue dick. We're not going to see a big blue dick. And my brother was complaining about that.
I was waiting for that.
My brother hated Watchmen.
Just for that? Well, if you saw that it in IMAX, that was a big factor. There was a giant blue dick.
There was a lot of people that hated Watchmen just because it was more story than action.
It was really good. I liked it.
The storyline was amazing, but that's what Watchmen was supposed to be. It was supposed to be mostly storyline.
I know I can get hated for this, but I like the ending to the movie better than the book.
You know what? I don't hate it. At first I was like, oh man, they changed it. But then I realized it's more real world. Like,
In the comic, there's
a giant fucking octopus.
Yeah, I literally didn't catch it the first time I read it.
Yeah.
I was like, this is kind of left field.
I was like, I don't understand. It's so random. But this seems a little more like current.
Yeah, real. It made sense.
Yes. You know, so I didn't have a problem with it.
All they all turned against Manhattan. That's awesome.
Mm-hmm.
Unite the world.
It. Yeah, it was cool.
That guy should show up in a DC movie again. Ozymandias.
Ozymandias.
That actor.
Is Watchmen in any other universes?
Or was it? They're in their own.
No, they were published by DC, but it's their own thing.
Yeah. Okay. I didn't know it was published by DC.
But Jeffrey Dean Morgan, the comedian.
Yes.
Totally playing Thomas Wayne.
Yes, I saw that.
I was like,
how cool is that?
That's awesome.
How cool is that?
I was like, now I want him to play Thomas Wayne Batman from Flashpoint.
Yes.
That's all I want.
I was listening to a podcast and someone was like, good casting on that.
I think I'll let you borrow it.
Okay.
Oh no.
Let me borrow it first.
Did I let Tom borrow and he never gave it back to me?
Was it a movie?
It's a Blu-ray.
Oh, I remember him saying you let him borrow it.
He still has it.
That bitch.
Well, good thing we still talk to him.
Yeah. Or do we? But I was listening to this thing and they were like, yes, I hope they did that on purpose to do alternate.
Because you don't cast that guy. I mean, maybe because he's working with Zack Snyder again. He knows him. But he's good, you don't cast him just to play
just
a
for
death
that
scene.
Small part. Yeah.
How many times are they gonna have to? How many times is Thomas Wayne gonna have to die on film?
More. I need more. Damn it! He's gonna have to just keep dying forever. I hope they just loop that scene 3 times.
They need to give him his own little alternate Batman movie. Which I think it'd be brilliant if they did that.
That'd be really cool. Is that the one where he's Batman and his wife is the Joker?
Spoiler alert.
Sorry.
That sounds familiar.
Fuck spoilers. We're just
Flash goes back in time to save his mom from dying, from being killed.
Yeah.
And he saves her, and it changes everything. Because time, you know, works like that in some cases.
Butterfly effect?
I don't think it's the butterfly effect. It's another effect that there's so many theories, but I don't know.
It wasn't like the movie Butterfly
it's
Effect
a parrot.
Where he changed that one little thing and then he comes back to the future and all of a sudden he has no legs.
It's a temporal parasox.
I haven't seen that.
Parasox.
Temporal parasox.
It's a good flick though. One of the animated movies, Flashpoint. I think it's my favorite one that they've made. And that one's dark as hell. Like they killed children.
Well, DC's pretty dark.
DC's always been more
Which
serious.
Is why I really want to see Suicide Squad, because I know it's going to be like, because they're going in a dark, you know, direction period, but Suicide Squad is just going to take it, like, much further, and I want to see it.
And before we talk about Jared.
Well, I was going to say, even we've gone so off topic, other than saying we like the Suicide Squad trailer, we have not to talk about anything in it. other than it was cool.
We'll say just like they did in the teaser.
We'll save Jared for last.
Okay. Yes. Oh, he's the last scene.
Okay. Perfect. We'll start with
Big Will.
God damn it. That was like it wasn't just an eyesore in the trailer. It was an earsore every time. Like everything.
Really?
Yes. Because
Will Smith in that movie.
Everything. Whenever they were like, you know, it was all dark and the music was cool, and then I hear Will Smith's voice and he's doing every single fucking. Hey guys, we're gonna be doing this, and they're like, no.
Suicide Squad, or is it? Guess let's save the day.
Yeah, I was like, no, Will.
And why was he walking around without his mask so much?
I'm going to let him do his thing.
No, but that's not...
He was cast in the movie for a reason.
He's cast just because he's a semi-good actor.
They cast very well.
Well, no, Will Smith is a good actor. I really like him as an actor. But I like the character that he does.
The I Am Legend character?
I Am Legend character.
You like his... Oh, you like the I Am Legend actor? The character? I Am Legend?
But not in Suicide Squad.
He's not going to play I Am Legend. Okay.
He kind of already was.
It's just he seems like he's Will Smith in everything, and he's exactly the same. But for some reason, it just doesn't fit.
No, normally...
Even just him walking. It just looks like an old man, like, in a costume.
It fits in everything else. Yeah, exactly. His character didn't mesh. Like, yeah. Harley Quinn, that meshed. That was like, no, I can believe that's Harley Quinn.
She was the trailer.
Yeah.
She was the trailer.
So but it kept feeling like Will Smith was trying to take the trailer. Because every time I heard his voice,
because
I was
he's Will
like,
Smith,
I'm gonna reserve judgment.
I'm pretty sure that Will Smith was like, "Look, I'm gonna be this guy, and I don't want to wear the mask that much because this is Will Smith face."
I mean,
I don't think he did
seen.
That.
He's gonna use it when that's an actor contract thing. They have to show actors' faces. You know, that's why Captain America's
they took off his
helmet.
Little helmet.
It comes off after half the movie's over every time.
Well, but no.
Well, it wouldn't make sense to wear the helmet all the time.
No, I know. But
clearly, Will Smith is walking with everyone. Which, by the way, there were way too many walking group scenes in that trailer.
Dude, they've been filming for like a couple of weeks.
I know, but it was just like they literally had nothing else to show. Let's show them walking one way, walking another way.
You know what's funny?
Walking
though?
This way. This time, Harley's making like gun things.
You know what's funny though is that all of like set pics that people take. Is of those scenes of where they're on the street. And people are like, is this all they do in the movie?
Right now they're just walking.
Which is hilarious.
Did they just make that trailer for Comic-Con?
Yeah.
Yeah, dude.
Because they weren't going to release
it. We haven't shot anything yet, but let's just throw something out.
They were giving you like a teaser for it, but it was only going to be for Comic-Con. It wasn't expected to
Warner Brothers was very naive, and they were like, we don't like that people...
You think they would have learned from...
Like, I don't
last
know,
year?
The whole time Comic-Con has done movie trailers.
Yes.
But, I mean, every year they leak. Every year.
Mm-hmm. You know? The Batman Superman one
every
from
single
the year
trailer
before leaked
this year. What?
The Batman Superman one, the teaser, when he turns on the light and he looks up and
yeah,
sees.
That leaked as well.
That leaked. And, like, I guess this year they're like, well, we'll release one.
I mean, Suicide Squad is literally more than a year away. And I'm sure they were like, we do want to save this one for a little longer.
Yeah. I don't want them to fuck that one up.
I mean, they came to Comic-Con and they were like, we're gonna fucking win it.
Maybe maybe that's why Will Smith's character kind of stood out. Maybe because like they didn't even have like scenes yet where he did
possible.
Talking.
That's possible.
They're like, what if they just shot that in a booth? They're like, hey, we just need you to say a few lines for the trailer. Because now that I think about it, he doesn't really talk. Like they don't have scenes of him talking in the trailer.
Mm-hmm.
You just hear his voice.
Yeah, they do that a lot in trailers where they have like a
they
speaking
haven't shot
scene,
anything yet. So
they put
like,
other dialogue on top of it.
Yeah, they're like, let's just throw in a vocal booth and we'll throw it. That might
possible.
Be why it popped out a little.
Maybe. I don't know. I went more off of his face.
His face?
I felt like just,
I don't mind.
Just, I mean, it's...
I know
Warner
we're
going to
wait to
they
see.
They cast well. They're casting well so far.
And I think Will Smith is a good actor. I don't want him to be... Maybe
Look,
it's because he hasn't gotten into character
at
yet.
Least he didn't get cast as Green Lantern or something. Okay? He's Deadshot. He's Deadshot. He'll be in one movie. He might be in the Batman movie as a side villain.
Mm-hmm.
That's about it. He's not going to have his own movie, so we're not going to have to deal with him too much.
Do you think like he'll just be in this one? Like they're not going to do any more Suicide Squad stories?
If it's a hit, they'll continue that. I mean...
I think it's going to be a hit because a lot of people like... Harley Quinn and a lot of people.
I can't believe
Joker.
We're getting Harley Quinn on film.
That's really
that's
cool.
You know, y'all know how she originated, right?
Like, she was originally the psychiatrist for the Joker, right?
No, how she was created, like where she was created.
Like in that vat of chemicals too?
No, like not in the story.
Oh,
like she was created.
Was it because some guy was like, I like the word Harlequin. Harley Quinn.
No, she originated in Batman the Animated Series.
Oh,
she originated in like 93, 94.
That was when she was
animated series.
I thought she was at least in the comics before that.
No, she was in the show first.
Really? Because she was so good in the animated show.
She was an original character from the...
She was like one of my favorite characters in that show. Yes. Though, because her character really popped out in that. Like the one episode that still sticks in my head
is
she tried to... it was that episode where she caught Batman and she had him going into like a tank of piranhas. And then the Joker came and he was like, what are you doing? And she was like, oh, I did this and this. And he was like, but why is Batman upside down? And she was like, oh, because when he's upside down, then it looks like the fish are smiling. And then Joker got really mad because she had to explain the joke. Mm. That was like something that always stuck out to me. And like,
I'm actually watching that, slowly watching that on Amazon.
Oh, it on Amazon?
It's on Prime. And they have that.
I think someone's trying to break into your house. Hello?
Hello? Hello?
You hear that, right?
Sprint asks you to please silence your cell phones. Man, that was really scary.
Hello? Hey, what's up?
Well, that was fucking creepy.
What y'all doing?
I'm grabbing something to use as a weapon.
We're getting remotes and donuts.
Okay, remotes in the drawer, donuts in the kitchen.
You have donuts?
Just the little chocolate donuts.
Ah.
I feel like we weren't told about the donuts.
Yeah, because I don't want to share.
Hey, he's honest.
That's true.
Yeah. Seeing you.
At least you shared the pizza. Oh, no, he didn't. We bought our own pizza.
We bought your own pizza.
We did buy our own pizza.
There is no sharing. Okay, so...
He shared his knife.
I did. With me. I'm a nice guy.
With me, Kramer.
He needed his knife anyway.
He held my hand. He gave me his knife. And we didn't do anything with the knife. Thankfully.
Yeah.
It's okay. He held more than my hand.
Woo.
Huh?
Okay, so if we go back to what we're talking about.
Harley Quinn was originated in the animated series.
And you know what? That voice sticks with me forever. Of like, you never
forget. Tara Strong Pops is her name.
Mr. J.
Mr. J.
Oh, like, I listened to that podcast where she was on Kevin Smith.
Oh, Fat Man of Batman, yeah.
That one was really cool with her.
That was me.
Yeah, I mean, Suicide Squad's looking really good, and it's got... I'm liking that... like, do y'all know who Amanda Waller is?
From
she's a writer?
She's no in the movie. There's a character, the one who's putting it together, the super villain.
Oh, okay.
She is a more ruthless Nick Fury for DC Comics.
Really?
Yeah.
Hmm. So you think, I guess spoilers?
Oh, the Black Lady. Okay.
Yeah. Spoilers? Are they gonna show?
Damn, I'm gonna sound really racist now.
Oprah.
She almost got that part.
What?
She was a front
Oprah.
Yeah.
No, the actress, what's her name?
Oprah?
No, the actress that they chose.
I think it's Viola Davis.
I don't want to keep calling her the Black Lady. That sounds really racist.
Viola Davis, I think.
She's a really good actress.
Yes.
What was she in?
She plays that role a lot, though. The government person.
Really?
What was she in? I didn't recognize her from anything.
It's hard to say, but Google's? I've seen her in films.
Nah, fuck Google. It takes too long.
I got it. Just keep talking about Viola Davis and how good of an actress she is.
I was going to say Oprah Winfrey. Color Purple.
I'll give
it to her.
No, I wouldn't give it to her.
She is an
actress. You know who I'm glad they didn't choose?
Who?
Whoopi Goldberg.
Oh, thank God. I hate Whoopi Goldberg.
She was in The Help. She had a huge role in The Help.
I didn't watch that.
With Emma Stone.
Didn't watch
it. Doubt. She's in the show How to Get Away with Murder.
Nope, never seen
it. I've seen that one, yeah. Again, government thingy.
Ender's Game. Prisoner.
She was in Ender's Game?
Yeah.
I did watch that. Was she the one that was like,
she starts in Spider-Man.
You gotta leave him alone.
Wait, no,
he's just a boy. Funny. Was that her?
I didn't see Ender's Game.
Oh, fuck.
Prisoners. Prisoners was a good movie.
I didn't see that either. Damn it.
She's in a lot of movies, though. And she always does a good job.
You have to trust us on this.
All right, fine. I thought she was okay. I didn't.
No, yeah.
In the chair, she looked fine.
Amanda Waller is very... She's, she's exactly how she appeared in that trailer.
Okay.
You know? She says...
it's very ominous. I like
She sees things.
She says
things.
She controls stuff.
Yeah, specifically she says...
She likes dark holes no one will find. That's 3 out of 3 right there.
That's a good line, though. That's a good line. Yeah. I put him in a hole and threw away the hole.
My hole.
Can we talk about Jared now?
Wait.
Harley Quinn.
Oh, what did you... Okay.
Harley Quinn looked like crazy.
No,
she looked
great.
Pretty psycho.
And it looked like there's a scene in there where she's being tortured by a white arm and a purple glove.
The Joker.
Her origin.
Yep. But that's not originally her origin, is
no,
it?
No, she wasn't tortured. No. Her
origin was she was a psychiatrist for the Joker, and then like she fell in love with him.
He molded her and
manipulated her.
He manipulated her.
Yeah.
I didn't
see it as manipulated.
He didn't really manipulate.
She kind of just like fell in love with like I guess as a psychiatrist, she fell in love with like the mystery of his psyche or whatever.
She was enthralled with his
She became obsessed.
Spirit.
Yeah, she became really obsessed, and then it like drove her crazy.
But in this one, it looks like it's going to go a little deeper than that. And he's very abusive.
There's actually a theory circulating right now about why it may have been, like, specifically with the Joker, because a lot of people are a little iffy about the Joker because he looks very different.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
The way Sammy put it was, she was saying he looks like how the Joker actually would be if somebody became a crazed criminal. Like somebody who already had like tattoos and shit, and eventually like all that shit happened to him.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
Whereas you know in the other one where it's you know a guy in a suit and all that, like especially the.
You mean Heath,
the Dark Knight?
Not Heath. Heath is believable. Who's like one of the older ones? Jack Nicholson's. I just laugh every single time I see that Joker.
Because you see him goofy. As playing Joker, like playing a character.
Yeah. Whereas like Heath Ledger's was a really convincing like. Criminal Joker, like an insane guy.
Crazy criminal.
Jared Leto's, just by looking at it, it kind of reminds you of somebody who's like been in a penitentiary.
Very psycho.
Yeah, it's something like you, kind of more relatable as an actual person who's been in prison and eventually went crazy.
One of my friends was just like, I can't stop looking at his eyes.
He doesn't blink and he has no eyebrows.
Really?
He doesn't blink, there's no eyebrows, and that's why you're just staring at him like, what's wrong
and
with
they're
him?
Real dark and
yeah, you're
he's
look
got
at
it
him.
Down, dude. He's
dude, I know a lot of people don't like the tattoos. I like the tattoos.
Yeah, I think they're charming.
Charming?
Honestly, charming? Like for Joker, like it's kind of charming.
I like the ha-ha tattoo.
Yeah. I'm gonna be the bad guy that say I still don't like the tattoos.
You don't like the tattoos?
No. Yeah. I'm going with it. I'm not gonna hate
on
it. I'm not gonna like
hopefully
say
it's not
the worst.
Do you not like it because he looks like a cholo Joker?
No, I don't like it because
I like the grill.
Some of them are really
the grill is nice.
Some of them are really dumb.
Well, those aren't.
The grill's cool.
No, that's not a grill. It's they're
the fake teeth.
They make sense because if he was like dipped in that vat of acid, like
or if he was beaten the shit out of.
He was punched in the face by Batman.
Oh yeah,
they're crowns. They're
yes,
crowns.
That he wouldn't have teeth. That makes sense. Cool. The jester tattoo, whatever.
Mm.
The ha ha ha. I felt was just stretching it. And the other tattoos I really don't mind. I guess that's the one I hated. Well, and the damaged one on his face.
I would like it if they say he put it on himself.
Well, but this is
yeah. And if they were like weird and like scrawly looking like he did it, I could totally see that. But I can't see the Joker coming to a tattoo shop and be like, you know, I laugh a lot.
Well,
I like
see,
to
but
put ha 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 all over
That's what I'm
me.
Saying. Like it could have been
it's
like
kind of my thing.
It could have been like when before he went completely crazy.
And that if they explain it that way, I'm okay with it. I think.
Yeah, like back when before
if
when
he was
a
like,
regular criminal.
Well, the thing is, he's always been an amoeba. Like, there's no origin for him, per se. He just appears.
What about Red Hood origin?
Yeah.
Red Hood?
When he was a part of the Red Hood gang and he falls and they
trick
him.
Yeah, that was like a...
Was that like a one-shot alternate universe?
They never explain that as like, we're writing this book and it's going to show Joker before he's Joker, but this isn't really his origin, you know? Like, maybe this is his origin, but it's just a story.
So you're saying it's not canon?
It didn't seem canon. No, it definitely doesn't seem
well,
canon.
It's like a rumor.
It's a very self-contained book.
Because we're talking about killing
like,
Joker,
because
right?
I know.
But I mean, he did shoot Barbara.
And they kept that going because she kept being paralyzed
yeah,
and
right,
she became Oracle.
Excuse me.
Well, okay, with comics, because I know in animes they have canon and then they have filler. With comics, is it all canon or is it just all several storylines?
I don't recognize filler in comics.
Yeah, it's all canon unless it's an alternate universe or something.
But there's a lot of alternate universes.
Okay, I know
like which one. Which
know,
one is canon?
No,
canon.
I know exactly what filler is in comic books.
Okay, where?
Point one or point two, point three, point four issues.
Ah.
Like this is issue 700.
Weird in betweens.
Yeah, just those little stories that they do on the side.
Okay,
but they won't affect the main.
But
story.
Alternate stuff where it's like Thomas Wayne is Batman instead of Bruce.
Yeah.
That's Elseworlds. That's what they call it.
Okay.
So that's alternate.
Mm-hmm.
And which, it's is still not, which is, of course, that's canon for that universe.
Yeah.
Okay.
It means everything is canon. It's just in different things.
Just retellings.
The multiverse.
Different dimensions.
Yeah. I guess that's what always confused me, because I grew up with anime before I grew up with comics.
That's cool.
Like, I'm actually just barely getting into, like, comics. But, like, I grew up with, like, anime. And anime, the manga, that's the storyline.
Yeah.
It's that's it. That's canon. Whereas, and that's what always confused me about comics, because every time I tried to get into comics, I was like, I don't understand. On the show, I see this. In this comic, I see this. And in this comic, I see this.
Yeah.
Where it got a little confusing. Where, and that's also like where that theory that Tom showed us came in for this Joker was that this isn't the actual Joker in the movie.
Mm.
It's a different Joker. And do you remember the whole theory?
Yes.
I remember part of it. Do you want to tell it?
Okay, yeah. The theory is that that Joker is not the normal Joker. He is Jason Todd as the Joker.
Whoa.
Really out there, right? Basically, this is what they're kind of saying, that since in the Batman Superman, you see the Robin suit, and it's got spray painted on there. So Jason Todd is dead. At, mm-hmm. In this universe.
Yes.
So since he eventually comes back as Red Hood, they're thinking that at times he's got like a similar, well, very similar, like taking on the Joker role.
You know what almost justifies that?
What?
Is that Batman Beyond movie they did, The Return of the Joker.
Oh, where he was.
Where Tim he, was.
Tim, the original was Robin Tim became, yeah.
And yeah, because he had some sort of something on him that made him the Joker.
So it's kind of the same thing, except like...
Spoiler alert.
So Jason Todd doesn't die. His teeth are all knocked out from being beaten by the original Joker.
Can
with
I
the
just
crowbar.
Say, you have to stop saying spoiler alert after you say things.
I know.
Okay, so that would explain missing teeth.
Yeah.
Okay.
And then... what else?
Torturing Harley Quinn.
That he's torturing Harley Quinn just because...
That looks like a flashback, though. Well, I mean, then again...
Oh, no, 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 no. The torturing Harley Quinn, I think that wasn't too much into it.
I don't think they had the balls for that.
To go that deep into it?
That's too bold.
And then they were saying...
For a movie studio.
This is how you do it, Ryan. Spoilers first. Arkham Knight...
Wait! I'm playing that game.
Oh, fuck you then, Ryan.
I already know that...
You know that
you've ruined like half the shit that I was eventually never going to read or watch anyway.
You don't seem like you care.
He cares. You never told me that. Ryan cares.
You shouldn't have said that, Ryan. You shouldn't have said that as well, Ryan.
He's just mad that you said spoiler afterwards.
I just think it's
okay. Fun. Okay. Well, in Arkham Knight. Do you know what I'm talking about? Like the ending already?
Yeah. No, I don't know the ending.
Do you know who the Arkham Knight is?
Yes.
It's, okay.
Do you mind?
Sure. Go ahead.
Are you gonna play it?
Maybe.
He's not gonna play it. Just don't even say maybe.
Just
he's
watch,
not gonna play
just
it.
Just watch it on YouTube.
He's
it's
not
a,
gonna play
it's
it.
It's a good game though.
So the Arkham Knight is Jason Todd.
Yes.
Jason Todd in the Arkham Knight has the little J tattoo somewhere on his face, just like Jared Leto too.
Interesting. What?
Jared Leto has a little
he
J right here.
He does have
right
the
here.
J, like right here.
Right
he does.
There.
That's not a tear.
No, it's not a tear. And I want to say there That's was a little weird. More to it. But I can't remember.
Well, they'll talk about anything else about the Arkham Knight.
They were saying that there's also the connection because Jason Todd becomes the Red Hood later on.
Yeah, and he's
and
yeah,
how
good.
Like the Joker was originally the Red Hood.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. So since he's already had That's like history of taking on the role of the Joker, they're saying, well, what if he's still doing it again? And what if that note was from Jason Todd when Bruce opens it up and he sees you could let your family die?
Okay, well,
which I assumed from was the Joker, but now that would take on a different meaning from Jason Todd.
Well, here's okay. I'm gonna go into my theory.
I love the little seizure he's having. He's like, his mind can't handle what's going on.
There, he had to change position completely to tell.
He was like, hold on, I didn't change where I'm sitting at a 90 degree angle because his whole world has been turned upside down.
No, it hasn't. Here's what I think. I think Warner Bros. Isn't bold enough to go that direction.
I would.
But you did say that they're using a bunch of writers who have had experience writing in the comics. So why wouldn't they be ballsy
but
enough?
Nothing like that has ever happened in the comics.
Yeah.
But why wouldn't it happen now? They need something to come back against
Marvel.
You got to think about the vast majority of people going to see the movie.
The diehard fans.
General audience.
They're not going to get it, yeah.
Yeah, they're going to be like, we just want Joker to be Joker. Why is he Robin? You know,
we don't understand.
Well, but those people
he
aren't
going to
care
Robin
anyway because they don't know what the original storyline is anyway.
No, they're going to see it regardless. You're always going to get the general public.
Yeah, so why would they care about the general public?
Because
the general
you still
public
have
is
to,
always
going to
watch.
You still have to appeal to them somehow to keep the everything going.
Man of Steel was hurt by... what fans were saying about the movie, what critics were saying about the movie, because it was like 50-50, and it did not make the kind of money that Warner Brothers wanted it to make, and what it probably could have or should have made, you know? So, things like that can affect general audience, can skew general audience's opinions on these movies.
I think I love that theory. I think it's really cool, but I don't think they're doing it.
No, I don't think
I cannot fully believe that they're going to do it, but I think it's a really, really interesting theory.
The J tattoo is a little too much, though. Like, if it is just a theory for them to both have the same tattoo in the same
place. Huge coincidence.
It could be a huge coincidence. Insanely
huge. I mean, that's like a celestial
Warner Brothers does handle both, so I mean, they could just... Easter
egg. Easter egg.
Maybe one of the other Easter things egg. Was that one of his tattoos
is a feather. It's a
so
feather tattoo.
It's a robin.
Whoa.
And he's got the jester with the
maybe it's
skull
his
face.
Homage to killing him.
The jester with the skull face is like his death and rebirth like thing. Was one of the things.
Or is it Cholo? You know,
so,
one of the two.
So there's a animated movie based on the death of Jason Todd and him coming back as Red Hood. And you should watch that too.
That one.
That was really good. Here's what I think. I think that Joker killed Jason Todd in these movies, in this universe. He killed him, and then he spray-painted whatever he sprayed. Ha-ha.
Jokes on you,
Batman. And he has that in his cave as a monument to Jason Todd, right?
Yep.
I think that the newspaper that said, "You let your family die," was from Jason as Red Hood. I think Jason Todd's going to be a villain in the Batman movie.
Ooh, that's interesting.
Which is going to involve Joker.
The standalone Batman movie?
What do you think? It's not going to be Jason Todd as the Joker.
No.
You think it's going to be the Joker and Jason Todd, but the Jason Todd might be the Red Hood?
Yeah, because he comes back as a villain, essentially. He comes back and tries to do what Batman's doing.
Better
save
Batman.
Save Gotham. But he's killing and he's controlling the mob. He's doing it in a very bad way.
I do like that. That seems like
because he's that's pissed what the that Batman never could kill the Joker after he was supposedly killed.
Yeah, he wanted him to like get revenge.
Yeah, so if he couldn't do that, he's gonna be a better Batman. By
and the way he
just
came,
killing people, ending
this,
it.
I don't think it's much of a spoiler to say the way he came back was the Lazarus Pit.
Mm-hmm.
So he literally came back from the dead. He didn't like almost die and then just ran off. No.
Yeah.
I think they're going to go that route with the movie.
But if they're trying to go with the more realistic stuff, which is what they seem to be wanting to do with DC, do you think they're still going to throw in things like the Lazarus Pit?
They're throwing Wonder Woman in there and the superheroes. So there's going to be real,
Enchantress,
but it's going to be the same
thing. There's a character in Suicide Squad, Enchantress, who's literally...
She gets her
that's
powers
magic,
like,
right? That's
from
magic.
The devil or something,
yeah,
right?
That's literal magic.
So does El Diablo.
Yeah, I think him as well.
Do you think they're both going to be the same thing? Like, we both just met this demon, he gave us powers.
I don't know. I don't know anything about them, actually.
I only know that he has, like, fire powers. Mm-hmm. And at one point in the trailer, he comes out of, like, a shell that's just water.
Yeah.
So maybe that's, like, suppressing him.
Killer Croc looks awesome.
He looks so cool.
Oh, my God.
He looks pretty awesome.
I'm wondering if he's going to go through stages.
Hmm? He has stages?
No, not necessarily, but he's...
Damn it, you raised my hopes and then crushed them.
But Killer Croc has looked very different in like the way artists have portrayed him and writers and stuff like that. Sometimes he's looked like Crocodile Man.
Yeah.
Not like skin
Isn't
cancer
that how he looks
man.
Like in the cartoon? Wasn't it like...
He looked like a crocodile. He looked more crocodile than man, you know?
Yeah.
I'm wondering he'll be portrayed as more crocodile than man in these movies.
Well, because I didn't recognize him in the trailer.
Really?
Because I've only seen him in the show.
He's the only ugly motherfucker.
It's true, yeah. I think he does.
And he's green.
Well, no, because I've only seen him in the show where he looks like a crocodile.
Oh, okay. Yeah. No, he's wearing like a hoodie.
He's wearing like a Letterman jacket almost, right?
Yeah.
And he does a couple, like, he turns to the camera where you can see his face, like, clearly.
Okay.
Razor sharp teeth.
Yeah. He looks pretty cool. He kind of reminded me of those Goombas from the original Super Mario movie. But better. A lot better.
But there's too many, like, Robin references in the trailer, Batman Superman, for me not to think they're going to include him somehow in this universe.
They have to include Jason Todd, right?
Yeah.
That's what you're talking about.
Who's the Robin that comes after Jason Todd?
Tim Drake. He becomes Red Robin. Okay, I'm ready to do this. Well, Dick Grayson came first.
Yeah.
He was Robin. He was the first one. He was the Flying Grayson, who was like the acrobat. And his parents died. Then he became Nightwing. And Bruce found Jason Todd. And Jason Todd was a very troubled kid. And he got killed by Joker. And then Tim Drake. I don't know how he came along, but Tim Drake was next. And he became Red Wobbin.
Red Wobbin?
Red Wobbin?
He became... What you say is he owns the chain of restaurants?
Red Wobbin. Yum.
He was like, I'm getting out of the game. I'm owning restaurants.
Based and, on my and then the burgers. Fourth one...
Damien?
Was his son, Damien Wayne.
Didn't he die?
Recently, he came yeah. back.
He came back?
He came back with superpowers for some reason.
What the fuck?
Spoiler alert.
God damn it, right? Actually, I should have said spoiler alert because I actually said it.
Yeah, you're like, Damien died.
Damien? He spoiler died? Alert. Yeah.
Yeah, Damien's an ass.
I've seen that. He's fucking, yeah, he's an asshole.
Yeah, because he was raised and trained by Talia al Ghul, who is Ra's al Ghul's daughter. Assassins.
Ra's?
I've heard both. Ra's I always say Ra's.
Family and the clan pronounce it Ra's. I've heard that the technical correct Arabic way to say it is Ra's.
Mm. I don't know. I'm Middle Eastern. I have no idea what the fuck you're talking about.
I think it's Arabic. I don't know.
I don't know.
They mentioned him in Arrow.
He fights him, right? At some point.
They mention him in Arrow, and
spoiler.
Like they say Ra's and Ra's. I mean, you know, like the family call him Ra's. Oliver calls him Ra's.
Yeah.
It's never been clear.
Okay, so Suicide Squad. I think we picked that apart. Kind
looks
of.
Good. Looks good.
From what we can. I mean, the teaser only had so much.
Yeah. Batman, Superman, we talked about that enough.
I think we've got... I think we might have over an hour.
Lex.
I'm pretty sure. Oh, what? Oh, man. Jesse Eisenberg is a little weird.
He's playing it exactly the way I thought he would play it. And... I'm waiting to see...
Oh, fuck, I forgot he was playing Lex, isn't he?
I'm waiting to see that when he loses his hair, he's going to change. He's going to change.
I completely forgot he was playing Lex Luthor.
That's not the Lex Luthor. I don't think.
Okay. Superman, no! Because gorgeous hair.
Dude, I completely forgot he was playing Lex Luthor, and the entire time I was watching the trailer, I was like, who the fuck is this guy?
It's because he has a horrible wig. It's really
and I'm wondering if it's an actual wig or if he's going to lose his hair.
Oh, if it's already gone, he's just wearing a wig.
But thing? I think that there's going to be a transformation for Lex in this movie, and then he'll go bald from that point on, and he'll be different. I think he's going to be way more...
I can't see him as Lex Luthor, though.
He's a little weird.
Well, it's because Lex Luthor, even though like he was, you know...
No, he doesn't fit the description of Lex at all.
No.
Because Lex
not
was
physically,
they're doing something
yeah,
really.
Physically he was always either like the bigger guy, like he wasn't like you know like quarterbackish.
He's always kind of like big,
it's just big stocky,
big
dude.
Yeah, big stocky dude. Or even like in the really that other Superman that came out where he was like where you could tell he was wearing like a pumped up suit or something. even that guy was even like he was a shorter, fatter Lex Luthor.
The old movies,
or yeah,
Kevin Spacey.
Kevin Spacey, I forget about.
Man,
him.
I
don't think it was Kevin Spacey
one. I love Kevin Spacey's look.
But like this is the first. The scrawny Lex Luthor?
Yeah, I mean, they're like, we're going to do something different here.
I think he's going to play the arrogant part
perfectly. But Lex, in more recent times, ever since like in the 2000s, he's always been portrayed as, instead of a businessman maniac, he's an arrogant fucking asshole.
Mm-hmm.
And he hates Superman with a passion for...
Being
possibly
good.
The wrong reasons, you know? And
I think they're going to do that.
I loved the shot of Superman kneeling before him, and he was like,
yeah, what was that? Like, he's kneeling, and he's, like, touching his face.
Yeah.
Kind of like...
You know, and he's, like...
It's almost like he was forcing him to do that, right?
It's like he's got something on him.
Yes.
You know?
That's what I think was going with that.
He was very dominant in that scene, and I like that.
I kind of got a little weirded out when he was doing the Red Capes Are Coming, and he was, like, singing it.
I don't know the reference.
Me neither.
The Red Coats Are Coming.
I know the reference, but I don't know what
the Paul Revere?
Oh, yeah. I didn't think about that.
It did strike me as odd, because I was like, there's only one of them.
I was thinking, okay, the Red Capes, are they those people in full body armor wearing that have Superman logos on their arm?
Oh my God! Batman in the desert.
Oh. Sand Batman.
I was like,
snapping necks.
That made no sense to me.
I
was like, what is that? What's going on?
He was totally breaking some dude's neck as they were like trying to like pull his arms.
The first time I saw it, I thought he was hitting a dude behind him.
No, as they're pulling his arms, he just snaps this dude's neck and he spins. And then they cut the trailer.
You don't do this to anybody without the intent.
He has his hand around that guy's neck and he just flips it.
I wonder if Warner Bros. Is like, well, we have a thing for that.
You know, it wouldn't be out of the blue because, you know, Superman snapped Zod's neck. People like that, right?
But that's, it's very, it's art. I think it's been confirmed that that is
that
Bruce.
That is him? Because I was wondering if that's one of the, you know, the sons of the Batman. Because he didn't quite look
but they,
like
they,
Batman.
They released, yeah, it looked, maybe it was a...
It looked like...
Maybe
like,
it was a...
That's kind of him because I had a really big jaw. And Ben Affleck has a big jaw.
He had like a scuff.
It could have been
beard
a,
going on. Scruff.
What were the actors that they do the stunt?
Stunt double?
Double, you know?
Maybe. Well,
I don't think you would need a stunt double for that part, though.
No, but what I'm trying to say is that they released an image of Ben Affleck in the cowl, in the...
And the, with the coat Batman, and the stuff?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. Because so, I was... Yeah, originally I was like... Is it not Batman because he's killing someone?
I mean, there's a couple of things in the trailer that are questionable. There's the really badass shot of him
grappling away,
paying homage to the Dark Knight Returns lightning bolt cover. Yes. First of all, and then using the grappling
hook, yeah,
to dodge heat vision.
Oh
it's a
yeah,
total kill shot.
Yeah,
and I don't think that's Superman.
Yes, I was about to say that. I don't think that's Superman either.
Because that was like a huge beam.
It was too big.
All. And it's a kill shot. It would incinerate him.
Yeah. Superman wouldn't have tried to kill
but
him.
But who else could do that,
Because he
though.
Knows he's human. The villain. The physical yeah. villain they all have to team up to fight at the end. Mm-hmm. That's where Wonder Woman comes in.
Yes, and I also think Wonder Woman... Because if you look when she's
you
fighting...
Shit? You see the shit? We're just connected.
When Wonder Woman's fighting, or when they show her...
Yeah.
I think when she kind of is like clanging her bracelets, the Batmobile is in the background, smashed against the wall.
I heard about that. Yeah.
So she's like... Obviously fighting someone.
Yeah.
I heard one theory
They made
was,
it look like a Superman, but that's obvious. I think that's a throw off.
One theory I had and that I saw was that since they kind of show Bruce and her in civilian clothes, kind of have... They know each other.
Yes, they know each other.
It's given away that they know each other. That maybe that's when Batman first meets Superman. And he's kind of sizing him up and he's not doing well. And Wonder Woman comes in and saves him so he can get away. That was a theory I read.
Interesting.
And then the second time, so now that he's got his info,
he
when he
armor.
Bites the second time, he's in the armor.
Yeah.
So she saves and him, is what I thought.
I think he's going to beat his ass the second time.
Yes, I think that's exactly it, but he has to that very first time.
I was under the impression Wonder Woman wouldn't even show up till the third act.
I'll give you that.
Like, I don't want her to be a part of the fight.
No.
I really don't want her to. If she's there, like the way you said it, it's cool.
But then she'd have to still be there.
She'd have to be there in some capacity. I've heard that she's just going to have a glorified cameo. And a glorified cameo to me is like joining their fight at the end. And that leads to Justice League. It's a Justice League formation movie.
Maybe she, after they're fighting the villain, at one point, Batman is cornered and she saves him that way. Because Superman can hold his own.
I kind of don't like the idea of like having a major villain come in though, and that's where they're like, oh, let's resolve this. Because like you were saying, that's what they always do.
Well, yeah, they have to
team up.
They have
to
come together.
They have to.
There has to be something big.
How would you end that movie?
I don't know. I'm not fucking writing it.
I still don't like you, Batman.
I still don't like you, Batman.
Yeah, because they have to fight, and I feel like they intentionally showed
the last shot, the last scene will be some of the members of Justice League coming: Aquaman, Cyborg, maybe Flash. They're all gonna be like, "Hey, we're gonna do this."
Well, but I can't accept, especially with the way. As angry as Batman is in the trailer at Superman, it can't just be like, oh, well, here's this bad guy. Let's beat him up together. And like, hey, I guess we can get along since we have to work together.
They're never going to get along.
They're going to have like, an organic way to get to their partnership.
Yeah.
Like, my brother and I think, like, Act 1 is going to be set up characters and throw in, you know, Batman-Superman conflict. Like, Act 1. That's what the movie's called. They're going to get right into that, I think. Act 2, 3 is where they're going to start resolving all that and introducing... There's going to be a... I bet you that we're going to see the villain throughout the movie. It might be Metallo or Doomsday.
I've heard Doomsday because they show Zod's body.
They can't put Doomsday unless he's going to fucking kill Superman.
Exactly.
And but I would save that for Justice League.
If you if you watch the trailer, you see that something has escaped from the LexCorp lab.
Yeah.
There's bullet shells everywhere.
It could be Bizarro.
Because
he's a clone of Zod.
Bizarro?
Yeah.
Bizarro Superman?
Bizarro Zod.
Bizarro Zod?
Because they have Zod and they're going to experiment.
And that could be the kill shot against Batman?
Maybe. I'm convinced that, like, there's a couple of shots. There's the part where Wonder Woman is in battle with someone. I don't think it's one of the heroes. It's especially not Batman. There's a shot of Batman dodging the heat vision. That's not heat vision. Superman.
Mm-mm.
That's a beam or something like that. There's also, in the first teaser trailer, they showed the Batwing.
Oh, right? Yeah.
And it was blowing some up. Shit up and blowing, like, some criminals up.
Somebody said that maybe that was a drone.
It could have been a drone, or it could have been taken control by Lex or something like that.
Yeah. Because it certainly looked like... Somebody wanted, like, in a video, I think, on YouTube, they're like, it blows up a couple cars, and there's guys there. Those guys are dead. They're dead. They're clearly dead.
They didn't get, like, incinerated.
Exactly.
They got hit by a bullet.
They got hit by a missile, and it blew up the car. Those guys that were next to there were
shrapnel, all
yes.
that shit.
Shrapnel. Like, so is this the universe where Batman is just not giving a fuck and just killing everyone? I mean, I guess I'm okay with that.
That would be interesting, because Thomas Wayne's like that.
Yeah.
And he has guns.
Ooh.
And that's, like, the great irony from is that he uses guns.
Did he have guns in the trailer?
No, I'm talking about Thomas Wayne. Batman.
Okay.
Like, in the Flashpoint alternate universe.
Yeah.
Someone says you can see Batman holding a rifle of some kind while he's standing on that
There's
building.
There's a reason for that.
Is that from The Dark Knight again?
Yeah, I'm not going to. Spoiler alert.
Spoilers.
Okay, it's a rifle to shoot a hook.
Yeah.
That's not too bad.
But it looks cool. It looks really cool.
That's fine. As long as he doesn't shoot into someone.
I thought you were going to say, like, he's going to shoot the Flash's ashes into the sea or something like that.
Like, what?
That's a spoiler. That's like, by the way, the Flash dies, and then Batman incinerates his body.
Why did you come up with that? How did you come up with that?
Where did you even...
That's really creative.
That
he shot the Flash's ashes into the sea with a grappling hook.
I don't know. I wanted some sort of, like, grand spoiler thing. That's what came into my head. Not, oh, yeah, it's a gun with a hook.
It's just a hook. That's it.
Well, he uses it in The Dark Knight Returns for hooking reasons.
So he's a hooker now? He's some kind of hooker?
So the grappling hooks aren't good enough?
He gets sexy time on with a helicopter.
Ooh. Oh.
What?
Do you think...
He shoots the helicopter. Okay. I'm making a joke.
Do you think since they're going that, like, Dark Knight Rises... I mean, like,
don't
Dark
mention
Knight.
That shitty shit.
No, not Dark Knight Rises. I'm thinking the comic, Dark Knight
Returns. You
don't
like
Returns.
The Dark Knight Rises?
Do not get him started, please. We're trying to go somewhere with this because he will keep going.
Okay, no. Shitty shit. That's another one. That's another podcast. It's another podcast.
Okay, since they're basing a lot of stuff like off the comic, do you think that the little girl he saves will eventually come back and be his Robin?
She wasn't a redhead, though.
She wasn't.
And they cast.
They can always change stuff.
Jenna Malone.
Oh, the one he saves from the building when it's collapsing?
Because I figured, you know, he's just hugging a little girl. But then I remember thinking about it, like, what if he saves her and then she becomes... Because in the comic, he doesn't pick her up, like, you're going to be my new Robin. She finds him. She saves him.
Yeah, she saves him.
And maybe she saves the Batman, not knowing it's Bruce, and then finds out that he's the one that originally saved her. Mm. I think that'd be kind of cool. Maybe not introduce it this movie, but maybe she come back. Or maybe that's... It doesn't have to be the same actor. Maybe it could just be like, that's the reference.
Mm. That'd be kind of cool.
Okay, so she was cast in the movie. People think that she's either going to be Robin.
Oh,
which
I've
is,
seen her.
Which is...
let me see.
She's worked with Zack Snyder before.
Oh, she's already cast in the movie?
I think... yeah, I think she's cast in the movie. But we don't know what...
Who is she?
Her name's Jenna Malone.
Jenna Malone?
Gina or Jenna?
I think it's Jenna.
With a J.
She was in something. I can't remember, but I've seen her.
She's either playing Oracle, which is Barbara in a wheelchair.
Yeah.
Or female Robin.
That would make sense because I heard that they're going to do the Killing Joke.
Yeah, there's rumors that we're going to get flashbacks to possibly seeing Jason's death.
Mm-hmm.
Or seeing Barbara's...
Barbara being shot?
Yeah, Barbara being shot. Paralysis.
Mm-hmm.
Right into the mic.
I did it that way. I did it away from
you
the mic.
You did it that way?
Yeah.
But you know, sound
you know
waves go everywhere.
It's a cardioid mic. It only mostly picks up when it's in front of it.
I don't believe that for a second. Anyway.
So,
that's interesting. I put so much work into that. Come on.
Okay, that's kind of cool. I could do, like, that's interesting.
She was in Hunger Games.
I didn't watch those.
Pretty good.
Okay.
Pretty good movies.
Well, okay, then let's move on to another movie, because we've literally talked about two things for an hour and a half.
Ant-Man was great.
I think
We'll go fast through other trailers real quick.
Which ones?
Fantastic Four, real quick.
I'm excited for that movie.
I'm on the fence.
It's from the director of Chronicle, and I'm biased.
Chronicle was good. Okay, definitely.
I did kind of like it when it was the way it was starting off. I was like, this looks really fucking awesome. But then Juan pointed out something.
The Thing?
Doom.
No. The Thing I like.
Oh, Doom.
I like The Thing.
The Thing, yeah, looks, the thing looks really great. Awesome in that.
He's in these pants.
It doesn't look cartoonish. It yeah. just it looks real. Real. Yeah.
Yeah.
Real.
Yeah. They did a good job.
But the.
What about Doom?
He doesn't look like Doom.
When they show him, he looks just like
he looks like a mini The Thing.
Like he's just green. Burnt, and he's got like cracks in him that you can see like green through.
What do y'all think Doom is?
But like, well, Doom is like he's disfigured, mask. And he gets the mask, but he looks like he's burnt, like the suit melted to him in the movie, and it looks weird. And they show him the second time, and he doesn't have the same face, and he's actually wearing what looks like a mask. And that's okay. But they show one weird thing with him where he looks like he has like cracks in his face where like green uh-huh. light is coming through and his eyes are green and like beady. Yeah, yeah. That part looks a little weird.
Green is his favorite color. But,
I like that they did in the little clip that they show him using like...
They fucked up Doom so much the first time around that I have to have faith that they're going to do it better this time.
I hope so.
Because he was so fucked up in the first movies.
I didn't even watch the first few Fantastic Four that they came out with. They didn't appeal to me.
I think the first one was better than the second one.
Yeah.
It's fun, but Doom was stupid.
I watched for Jessica Alba, really. That was...
Back in the day, yeah.
What was it they did with the Silver Surfer? Or not Silver, the guy eating the planets?
Galactus.
He was a cloud. He was a cloud.
He was a space fart.
A space fart. He was a cloud.
What was worse? Fart Galactus or Poop Parallax from Green Lantern?
Ooh, I didn't even watch Green Lantern. The one with the Ryan Reynolds?
Why don't you watch any shitty movies? Come on, man.
Why did nobody watch any shitty movies?
Next, we'll watch shitty Green Lantern. Hey, did you watch the leaked Deadpool trailer?
Ooh. Yes.
Did you hear the part where Ryan Reynolds is about to go under surgery?
I have it on my phone.
And he's like, don't put me in a CGI costume.
Please don't make the costume green. Or animated.
Yes, or animated. Too good.
Wait. There was a leaked Deadpool trailer?
Okay, we're jumping to Deadpool. Fantastic Four. Yay,
there was a leaked Deadpool trailer?
Yes.
Every Comic-Con trailer leaks, man. There's an X-Men one as well.
I didn't see the Deadpool one.
Did you see X-Men?
I saw that one.
Yeah, that one was pretty shitty quality. No, but I haven't seen that one. But it sounds good.
You can see bald James McAvoy, Xavier. That's really cool. I didn't like how Apocalypse looked.
He's going to change. The whole thing about him is that he changes.
He changes, yeah. He's able to change like every molecule and stuff. I get that. And, like, but right off the back, I remember being like, that's a little weird.
Yeah, a little weird.
But
it's a good
I read
actor.
That the actor was like, oh, but he'll change. I mean, that's his thing. And I was like, okay, well, if he changes.
He's supposed to be, like, 8-9 feet tall. He's
that's one of his forms. And if that's true, then I'm totally on board. Because the movie looks cool.
Storm
looks cool.
Nightcrawler looks cool.
Nightcrawler.
Jubilee
looks spot
on. Weird,
oh my god.
That we're seeing Jubilee.
Super cool.
Kramer
got nothing. No. It's okay. This is the Ryan and Juan podcast.
I'm sure Wolverine will be in the movie at some point.
Yeah, you know, they haven't showed him.
I think they're saving him.
He's going to be
there.
I hope
he doesn't have just a cameo. I was convinced he was going to be one of the Four Horsemen.
I thought so too. But like I'd be okay if he only has a cameo because at some point he's not gonna do any more. They have to have characters that can keep the movie going.
The next Wolverine's his last.
Yes, which is Old Man Logan. Oh man.
He pretty much confirmed it.
He did.
It was the first thing he said.
Exactly.
In the
title. Yes. So that I mean just.
And people are like, Hugh, we know you're not gonna say that shit to fuck with us. Like, I'm sure he meant it. Like,
exactly.
Here's a big hint, guys. That is practically the answer.
Like, so I thought in the trailer. Well, it's not in the trailer, I don't think.
I saw an image of Magneto. His suit looks great.
Oh, I didn't see his suit.
Red and silver.
I just saw a picture of him looking like he was looking into the distance. Mm. It wasn't really much of anything.
He looks like he's in a bad place in this movie.
He's going to be one of the Four Horsemen.
One of the Four Horsemen. Him, Storm.
Storm.
Archangel.
Archangel. Oh, yes. And
Psylocke.
Psylocke?
She's one of the Four Horsemen.
Psylocke
looks like just like.
Oh Psylocke. Yes, I'm like Psylocke, Olivia Munn.
Yes,
she looks awesome in the costume. Like
I can't believe they actually put that costume on screen. Do you know who Psylocke is?
It's very
no
revealing.
Psylocke.
I like that on Olivia Munn.
She's an Asian. She has. I don't know what her powers are really.
I just know she has swords.
Some sort of energy that she's like a ninja.
She shoots energy blasts and has a... She's a badass, like, ninja.
Yeah.
And she wears a skimpy outfit. Basically like a one piece.
I can't believe they put that on film.
People were didn't like that. I thought they were
going to be like black leather again, you know, or something like that. You know?
Yeah. Colorful costumes. Jubilee's wearing her jacket.
Yeah, yeah.
Which is Bryan
Singer,
80s.
Bryan so Singer has said, like, this movie takes place in the 80s.
You can do it.
Fans really want this, so they maybe we're going to see those classic colorful costumes.
Yeah. So overall, that looks super cool. Super excited for that.
But Deadpool.
Yeah.
That was almost a show stealer.
It was really cool. It was really funny.
I'm really hoping they release that. He said that in a couple of weeks we'll get it.
A good trailer? Quality?
Yeah, which it's been almost a couple of weeks.
It's been like two.
Did Comic-Con happen already?
Yeah.
What?
But they decided not to like put any of the trailers out after Comic-Con?
Fox is holding out.
Pretty much the only trailers that came out were Suicide Squad and Batman Superman. And
Suicide Squad wasn't supposed to.
And well, yeah, they actually released a statement saying like, we didn't want to do this. It was supposed to just be for comics.
But they I haven't looked up any of the leaked trailers. I've only been watching them as they come out.
Mm. That's just one.
That's fine.
Because I didn't want to, like, I saw, like, you guys were looking at the Suicide Squad one on your phones, the leaked one, and I was like, I don't want to see it like that. I want to see, like, it in quality.
Yeah.
Well, I looked it up.
You have the right mindset, according to Warner Brothers.
Yeah. I looked it up for the fact that they showed a Batman Superman teaser and never released anything, despite everyone in the world having seen
that shitty footage. And then they came out with the Comic-Con Batman Superman trailer, in, like, minutes after they showed it. And I was like... There's this. I was on YouTube. And I was like, "There's a 3.5 minute like trailer for this. Is that real?" I was blown away that they.
I think they learned from the first time.
I guess so.
Because they never released the good quality of that leak. It was a year. They literally waited a whole year.
That's the kind of trailer you release like 2 months before the movie comes out.
And yeah, it's still a year away.
That was so substantial, and I'm like, don't give me anything.
I hope they don't give any more.
Because
I'll watch
they will.
It, but
they will.
I would definitely. You know what?
I only watched 2 Avengers trailers.
I waited. Same with Ant-Man. Like, I waited till when they start getting closer and they start releasing, this is the final trailer. I'm like, I'm not going to watch it. When they get to the end, they always put way too much.
Mm-hmm.
Stop watching TV. Like, anytime he comes on, I change it.
Yeah.
Because then immediately after, they
because
give away
they spoil,
scenes.
They
show Falcon immediately
alert.
After.
They show Falcon in a commercial. I was pissed about that.
You saw that before the movie?
I saw a thumbnail.
Oh.
See, I didn't even see any of that.
Sarah saw the thumbnail, too, and she's like, I thought that was just Avengers.
Oh, I just actively avoided
which
all
that
of it.
Was amazing.
Yeah.
Him fighting Falcon.
Yeah, that was pretty
that
good.
That was cool.
That was amazing. Well, even more amazing was the actual end fight. I thought that end battle was great.
I loved it.
With Yellow Jacket.
Yes. Yeah. When they're in the suitcase.
So unique.
It was
so yeah.
Unique.
It what was the place, song that played?
The Cure? The Cure something.
The what? What?
It was the...
Incinerate?
What are you talking about?
I'm going...
The song that they play while they're in the briefcase fighting.
Oh, I don't remember.
Because he threatens him. He's like, I'm going to incinerate you.
And it's like, look up, incinerate or something.
Yeah,
and it plays
like
the song.
That. Something like that.
Yeah, that was really
clever,
cool.
Clever, man. But it was such a small movie. Took place in his daughter's room.
I liked it.
Yeah.
You can do that. Everything was super cool. I really, really enjoyed everything about it.
I'm ready to see it again.
I'd watch it again.
I told him yesterday, I was like, I spent $100 on Ant-Man memorabilia already.
What? You know what I've been wanting to read? I've been wanting to read Irredeemable Ant-Man because I heard he's just a perv.
Oh my God. And that's not Scott Lang. And
that's Eric O'Grady.
Yeah, it's the third one.
It's the third Ant-Man. And he's got Yellow Jacket arms. And he just watches women in the shower.
I've seen that exact panel. That's what I've seen about
it. I've seen one where who was it? It was some girl. And she was like, okay, the coast is clear. And he pops out of her boobs. And she's like, you know you can hide anywhere else, right? And he's like, but I like it here.
Oh, my God.
I want to read Irredeemable Ant-Man. Which I thought that was a reference when they talked about being redeemed. When Hank talked to Scott. I was like, is that an Irredeemable Ant-Man reference? And then I watched a spoiler, like a Easter egg video, and somebody was like, I think that was a reference. I was like, I thought it first. It's mine.
Yeah, I thought it before you made that.
I know video. I didn't make a video about it, and this podcast comes out afterwards. it was my thought.
I put like $20 for the ticket, you know, for IMAX 3D. I've bought a couple of the comics that have come out this year.
Did you buy the Prelude comic?
For the movie?
Mm-hmm.
No. I never read the movie stuff, movie comics. Not, I'm not against it. I just And then I bought a toy. An action figure. And then something else. I can't even fucking remember so much.
So if we talk just about like things we like from Ant-Man, you go fight scenes.
I think it was funnier than Guardians of the Galaxy. You okay?
Ooh.
Yeah.
I think it was right up there. I think I laughed probably just as much. And that's just classic Paul Rudd. And Michael Peña, his friend.
Michael Peña.
Oh my God. He was fucking hilarious.
He was so good.
He stole it, man.
I like the fact that I thought he was bullshitting Scott when he was like, I'm the only guy to knock that dude out. What's his name? Like Bubbles
oh,
or something?
Oh, he knocks some motherfuckers
and
out.
And then when they show him, he knocks people out.
That's
one
a
punch.
Great callback.
Yes.
I never thought about that.
Yeah, I was like, holy was shit. Like he really has a punch.
I mean, in the movie, I'm like, he got pretty lucky against those guys because they would have taken him down probably. Mm-hmm. Security guards. But no, yeah, that's a great
He knocks
callback.
Out at least two people.
Three?
Because
okay. He knocks out that guard. The first he's guy, like, oh, the guard.
Yeah, oh, yeah. He knocks out the guard because he takes his clothes.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
He knocks out the supervisor who's questioning him
okay,
in the
so
water
four,
pump.
And then two guys are shooting at
yeah.
him.
See, I completely forgot about that reference like at the very beginning where he's
yeah.
like, I'm the only one who knocked him out.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah.
I completely forgot about that.
Because it's like a throwaway line. And then you see like, oh, okay, I can believe that now. He's fucking like a boxer. Shit.
What was the Russian's name? Vlad? Vladimir?
I'm going to say it's Vlad because it's very Russian.
I like the way he talks.
Him and T.I., man.
T.I. is surprisingly good.
Yeah.
I like that.
Good comedy.
I like their little like combination.
They should have been a little more.
Yeah.
They were gone in the second act, but that's fine.
Yeah. I thought they did
thought
pretty
they,
good. I liked they were just in there right enough.
They were good supporting. They were able to draw away
the
cops. They
came back
cops.
At the right moment.
Yeah.
You know, he was like, we need a crew. Or we need this and this and this. And Michael Douglas was like, No,
not those three guys. I know who your crew is.
I like your house. It's a really nice house.
Yeah. I don't get scared, bro. Oh, shit.
The end credits was great.
Oh, yeah. We do spoilers. Starting now on the end credits, since we haven't talked about that. Ryan hasn't ruined it by saying that yet. Which end? First end credit? Wasp.
Yeah, they're both good. Like, they're both, like, not funny credits, you know?
Yeah.
They're just, like, this
Wasp
pertaining
cool.
to the Wasp suit.
Yeah.
Good.
Second
sure
one?
She had the same sentiments as, like, everyone, like, about him time.
Yeah.
For me, like, I was kind of hoping that was coming. I thought it was going to happen in the...
Because it's her name.
I thought it was going to happen, like, at the end of, like, the movie. I thought they were going to do something with Wasp. At the very end, and like she's the one who helps him or something.
Yeah, mm-hmm. I figured that as well.
And so
it seemed like it. She kept being like, "I can wear the suit."
She
I was waiting for him to
yeah,
be like,
"Ask about it."
Be like, "I love you. Here's the suit. Fine, take it."
I kept thinking it was gonna come up in the movie, and I was really happy when I saw it in that first end credit. I was like, "Yes."
Yeah, that's pretty cool.
Yeah, they had to.
Yeah, cause she's gonna come back.
I think we're also gonna see Janet, the mother.
Yes.
There was a shadow of her apparently in the.
I've seen the picture
microverse?
For it.
I don't know what it's called.
It was it's the microverse in the comics.
Microverse.
Quantum realm in the movie.
Okay, quantum.
See, to me, that was didn't make sense. And when we had this discussion, you were just like, Kramer, it's a fucking movie.
I was
did
like,
it make
comic
sense
books,
that
Kramer.
He grew back out.
No, no, it was that like if she did shrink into a microverse, it was on the other side of the world. You know, when they were doing
the
missile.
Well, I think he imagines the quantum realm. Like, I think Hank. Imagines it as another dimension.
That is kind of how he explained it. Like, you're in a place where time and space don't matter anymore. You're that small.
Time and space.
So you could be anywhere. It's,
yeah.
Oh, yeah.
That makes
space.
A lot of sense.
Yeah. Space between them doesn't matter.
I've seen it, and what the shadow does look like, you see wings, and you see someone kind of, like, outstretched.
Her suit looked great.
See, I didn't see that at all.
I had to watch the picture afterwards, because I didn't catch that.
Yeah, no, it's really subtle.
Someone says... Because when he's shrinking and you're hearing Michael Douglas's voice, when he starts repeating, you'll shrink for eternity, 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 that's when you see the shadow.
Mm-hmm.
But somebody was saying that maybe that's the actual character, Eternity.
Whoa.
Right? That he's in eternity. You're basically in his realm already. Like,
that
he's just there. And you see the snippet of him, and then that's it. So I think that's really cool, and
that's
that would because then because that all can kind of link to the microverse and Doctor Strange, which is going to come out next, right?
That's after Civil War.
After Civil War, right?
2016.
So you've introducing. Look, this is how weird things can get. If that is eternity, then you got Doctor Strange, and it all kind of connects full circle.
Yeah.
Which I think is really, really cool. Then you start getting into all the crazy cosmic Marvel magic. Stuff. Magic.
Magic.
Yeah.
Dark Strange is going to bring a lot of magic.
Oh, yeah. So I thought that was really cool. But at the end credit, okay, the last end credit.
The second scene is technically going to be a Civil War scene.
It's straight from the movie. Yeah.
But it's going to be, we're going to see it in different contexts, of course.
So Bucky's caught in some kind of machine.
Because I was almost not satisfied with the fact that, like, oh, they have him, you know?
Well, they've been trying to find him.
They're not going to have any fucking time in that movie to be like, we're still trying to find Bucky. You know?
They basically just gave that nod in Avengers when Falcon was like, yeah. I've been trying to look for him. Mm-hmm. And then they're going to jump into Civil War and he's going to be like, I found him, Cap. I remember I was looking for him when I said it that one time.
Edmund helped me. After he kicked my ass.
So I want to know, like, since they said that's directly taken from what they filmed already, how is he stuck in that weird machine? Like, what
happened? Yeah, I guess they're trying to contain him. And
because he looks kind of pissed.
He mentioned something, the Accords.
I didn't know what the Accords were.
And he didn't want to go to Tony for some reason. I don't know if it's distrust.
Has that already been like when like they've already started? Because it can't be at the beginning of Civil War.
What? Like their conflict?
Yeah.
Well, they film everything out of order, so that could be from any part of what... It's just something they filmed already.
Yeah.
So, well, I definitely assume that that's near the beginning, though.
It's probably
got to find Bucky. Well,
if it's the Accords and stuff like that, then it's the conflict of like the Civil War has already kind of happened.
What is the Accords? What am I
missing? I think
I don't know what the Accords is.
I think the Accords is when they're talking about like when they actually start doing the...
The Registration Act?
Yeah, the Registration Act. Like, it's not... If it's an act...
Well, they made it sound...
It's an act if it's just a national thing. I think an accord is more of an international thing.
Okay. That
because
makes sense.
Like peace accords. Like, when the UN does something, it's not an... like
politics. It's global.
Yeah, when the United States does something, it's an act. I'm using the wrong terminology, but, like, when they pass a law, it's an act.
This is why Black Panther's going to be...
Yes, I'm just thinking that right now. Wakanda. If they're going to show all of that, then that makes sense. Because I was thinking the way it described was that the accords was, like... A group of people.
Yeah, because the Avengers thing has been happening around the world. It can't just be the U.S. wants to do this.
Yeah, because they've already showed them.
Yeah,
around
so
the world.
Civil War isn't going to be like a national thing. Even when we think Civil War, we think American Civil War. No, it's going to be like international. That's why they would call it an accord.
Yeah.
This Whoa. This movie,
I like that a lot.
This movie is already going to be very different from the comic.
Yeah.
It's not going to be as. I don't think the scale is going to be as big because they had like. A massive amount of heroes and villains fighting, which they don't have.
They don't have that at all.
I think it's going to be a little more personal and small scale than that.
It's just going to be probably something along the lines of, like, people are tired of y'all guys' shit right now. Because you notice they mentioned that in Ant-Man, when he called it, and Paul's like, why don't we just call
it? Because they're like, they're busy call the Avengers. With cities falling from the skies.
Yeah, cities, they're doing that. And then in a newspaper, you see something, Sokovia, who's to blame? Mm-hmm. So.
Oh, I didn't even catch that.
So there's little bits already setting it up.
Very Man of Steel to Batman Superman.
So, I mean, I think that's a good...
Interesting like, that strong. All these superhero movies now are trying to convince not only audiences... Like characters within the universe, like these superheroes are good at what they're doing. They're trying to convince everyone that it's a time where superheroes are trying to, I don't know, being brought into a better light.
Yeah.
Which is interesting.
I'm waiting for the Spider-Man reference.
D23, Disney's thing.
Couple weeks.
They're gonna hit it out of the park with that. Civil War, Spider-Man.
That's why they weren't at Comic-Con, because they have their own thing now.
I think we're going to see a lot of footage and pictures.
Anyone else get super excited for Star Wars? No?
I got so excited and pumped with Batman Superman. But Star Wars makes me cry every time I see that trailer. I get crazy emotion. It looks good.
Yeah.
I think it's going to be fantastic.
Well, I think we pretty much covered at least three things super in-depth and completely...
We definitely dissected DC.
Everywhere. Well, we didn't go scene by scene, but we talked a lot about them. That's a good info. And I guess...
Oh, Kryptonite.
Oh, yeah, they did show Kryptonite. You're right. I think that's why that person was diving in the ocean, probably to get it.
Yeah, that's what I think as well.
Mm-hmm. Were you? Do you think that Kryptonite came from the sky or something produced by the gravity machine?
Gravity machine. Because it was changing into Krypton, so...
Yes.
Oh, yeah.
Awesome.
Do you think that's where they're going to bring Aquaman in?
Maybe yes, he's
that's,
pissed,
no, that's exactly
right?
That's exactly what happened, because it was in the ocean.
Yeah.
Over there where Superman stopped the machine.
Yeah.
He fucked shit up down there.
And he's like, "What the fuck,
I'm sure,
guys?"
He was taking a nap, and some crazy shit was going on.
He's
in
like,
his
"That's where
kingdom.
I had my volleyball court."
That's probably exactly why he's gonna come up. Yeah.
Atlantis.
He's gonna be super pissed. He's gonna be like, "I know you guys didn't know we're here, but fuck you, we're here."
He's like,
"I had a sweet volleyball court.
I just finished landscaping this area, oceanscaping.
Just got all my things the way I like them." Yeah.
Okay. I think we're ready to wrap this one up.
Yeah.
This was fun.
This is cool.
I can't wait to do another one of these.
Yeah. Good talk. Good first episode. And by then, hopefully, when we do the next one, something will. Fantastic Four will be out. We can talk about Fantastic Four.
Man, that comes out on the 7th.
DBZ.
Oh, we'll talk about Dragon Ball Z.
We also have to talk about DBZ.
You know, I really wanted to commentate Battle of Gods.
Oh my god.
The extended.
Hey, that could we could save. Oh no, never mind. But
I think
we can still do that.
I think the next one should be definitely Dragon Ball Z.
Next time on the podcast.
Yes. I like that Kai music. Don't stop, don't stop. Oh, that song is so catchy to me. I sing it all the time.
I haven't even seen that one. I refuse to watch Kai.
It comes on all. They play 2 episodes on Saturdays.
Isn't the US Kai
it's
version?
Good.
There's only 2 acceptable Dragon Ball Z theme songs to me. Chala, hey, chala.
Well, that's the original and the best.
Yes.
Yeah.
Or
Dragon.
Rock the dragon.
With that super metal riff.
Oh, man. That was great.
Yeah.
That was in the same song.
Exactly.
Okay, so next time on the podcast, Dragon Ball Z, because the movie will come out.
And Fantastic Four. It's the same week.
Dragon Ball Z, Fantastic Four. I don't know, anything else we've come across. We're jumping to so much stuff that...
I'll convince y'all more about Man of Steel next time.
Actually, this, also I want to talk about some other stuff, because me and my brother have been having arguments about other animes that he was saying influenced Dragon Ball Z.
Oh.
Other animes?
I think
Dragon Ball Z is influenced by Superman.
Was it...
Ooh.
Yes.
In a lot of ways. There's
some
sweet similarities.
Save it. Right.
Yeah, next podcast. Okay.
No problem.
So this was our first episode of the Nerdy Geeky Shooting Blanks podcast. We'll have actually a name for it maybe next time.
At some point.
Yeah. I'm Kramer.
I'm Juan.
I'm Ryan.
And we'll see you guys next time.
Bye.
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 Okay, bye. Bye.
Let's go eat pizza.
Yeah.